scandal. I declared him to be a dirty cop. Nothing proved it more than his interview yesterday with Chris Wallace.
Rump swabs, hacks, and moon bats beware. It's Howie Carr.
A dirty cop. Unfortunately, Joe DeGeneva will not be with us today. He'll be with us on Wednesday. He's on a plane right now, but that was what he said earlier this morning on WMAL in Washington, D.C. Welcome to the Howie Carr Show. I'm back in the Arctic climes again for a week visiting. We got all the VIPs are here. We're going to have VIPs every day. Welcome, VIPs. You're going to have good, you have good food, all kinds of good stuff, and my super beats finally came in. So you're going to have some nice super beats today too, if you want them. 844-500-4242. That is the toll-free number of the Howie Carr Show. And if you ever get dragged into court charged with robbing a bank or having a trunk load of fentanyl in, stopped by the cops or, try any kind of horrible crime, just, how do you plead? Guilty or not guilty? Sloppiness. That's all you got to do. It was just sloppiness, How bad is that guy? I was thinking about making the poll question, who's a worse FBI director or a more disgraceful FBI director, J. Edgar Hoover or James Comey? But then I figured, Comey is of the present, whereas we've all put Hoover in the rearview mirror, so that's not a good question. So I think we got a different question for you. 917, I'm now comforted to know the FBI is stupid, not corrupt. What was one of our poll questions last week? Is the FBI more stupid or more incompetent or more corrupt? And it's both, obviously. But the more you read of this report, Rush was talking about this today. He said the report came out a week ago, and you don't want to keep going over the old news, But it's the thing was over 400 pages. It takes time to digest it. And then you have these people coming on and defending it. And it really is indefensible. Somebody used to work here in Boston, now in San Francisco, Deb Saunders. She said on CNN, they were saying that Bill Barr's criticisms of the FBI could have a chilling effect on the agencies. And Deb Saunders said, and I think I agree, after reading that report, I don't want a chilling effect on him. I want him in a deep freeze. I don't want him coming after me or anybody else. And it is so, so disgraceful. 844-500-4242. Grace was saying earlier today, though, what does it tell you about Chris Wallace that not only James Comey wanted to come on and defend himself on Chris Wallace's show, but also Adam Schefter. I don't think that speaks well for your journalistic chops. Although, Chris Wallace, he did okay. And Comey wasn't going to go on with any hard-hitting people, that's for sure. He just couldn't, he couldn't handle it. The guy is just such a fraud. It's breathtaking. Both he and Schiff. Schiff, if you were, handling intake at some kind of a treatment facility or just an insane asylum, can you say that word anymore? Insane asylum? I don't know if you can.
How dare you?
But you'd be saying to yourself, that guy's eyes are really weird. When I'm down in Florida, I don't have a TV in the office, but the next office over is John Cardello, and sometimes I go over it. He has this HD TV, and I sit there and watch it with him. I'm telling you, you don't want to watch Adam Schiff on an HD TV. It's kind of scary. It's those eyes, they're Village of the Damned eyes. And the thing is too, it's one of these weird, it's psycho, it, I don't know, it's beyond sociopathic. I think it's psychopathic. Everything he accuses Trump of, everything he accuses Republicans of doing, he's doing it himself, only many times worse. Now Schumer's doing, Schumer, we want to have a fair trial. Right. They want to have a fair trial in the Senate. They're going to bring in witnesses that Nadler and Schiff couldn't be bothered interviewing, but they're going to have a fair trial. I'm more convinced than ever now that there's no need for a trial, that this is just the instincts of Lindsey Graham and Mitch McConnell. I know they're swamp creatures and they have hack tendencies, but I think in this case, their instincts are correct, that there's no point in this. You know why there's no point in having a trial? It doesn't matter what the evidence is. I mean, we saw that last week with the Inspector General's report, FBI cleared of bias. And now it becomes increasingly clear with each day that goes by and as you dig deeper and deeper into it and you read more and more stories about it, the FBI is at an all-time low level. As I said, they've become the secret police, the Ku Klux Klan, what the Ku Klux Klan was for the Democrat Party in the 19th and 20th centuries. That's what the FBI is now. And yet the mainstream media was clearing them. Gordon Sondland.
The Ku Klux Klan.
Gordon Sondland said there was no quid pro quo. What did the headline say? Sondland, there was a quid pro quo, right? So it doesn't matter what Mulvaney says or any of these other witnesses, fact witnesses, that the very ethical Chuck Schumer wants to bring in. It's going to, that's it. It's Trump did everything that we're accusing him of. 844-500-4242. We're going to take a lot of calls here and we got a lot planned for the day and later in the day, in the last hour, they're going to unveil their plan for a second tax on gasoline tomorrow to save the polar bears. Unless, of course, the press conference on global warming is canceled due to the impending snowstorm. The impending autumn snowstorm, because it's still fall. 844-500-4242. Someone says, does this mean Biff will be on standby for the snowacopalypse tomorrow? Yes, I believe he will be. Yes. Someone says, I have more respect for J. Edgar Hoover and he wore a dress. That was a rumor. Okay. That's all it was a rumor. 844-500-4242. I guess the first word is, remember when Clinton said, it all depends on what the meaning of the word is. And then, as I said on Sunday, you know, when they announced that the temporary emergency tax increase of 1989 was finally going to be ended, I said, I guess it all depends on the meaning of the word temporary and emergency. But now we have a new dueling definitions question. Vindication. Cut four.
The IG says you should feel no vindication.
Well, maybe it turns upon how we understand the word. What I mean is that the FBI was accused of treason, of illegal spying, of tapping Mr. Trump's wires illegally, of opening an investigation without justification, of being a criminal conspiracy to defeat and then unseat a president. All of that was nonsense. I think it's really important that the Inspector General looked at that and that the American people, your viewers and all viewers, understand that's true. But he also found things that we were never accused of, which is real sloppiness. And that's concerning, as I've said all along, has to be focused on. If I were director, I'd be very concerned about it and diving into it.
If you were sitting in a grand jury and I was the foreman or the prosecutor, I'd say, Mr. Comey, I'm going to remind you here that you're under oath. Would you like to correct your testimony here at this point? So I think, you know, so at one point, Wallace brings up the fact that this guy Kleinsmith, this is the lawyer with the goatee who texted out "Vive la Resistance" after the election and said they're gonna do away with Obamacare. I hope so. This is the guy who got the email from the CIA saying Carter Page is a reliable source, and he changed it to Carter Page is not a source. You know how Comey eerily described it as this business with the lawyer changing some email. Eerily.
This business of the lawyer changes some email. Forget about it. Not a big deal.
An email to a partner on the team. That would the partner on the team, would that be the judge in the FISA case? He's a partner on the team. 844-500-4242. That is the toll-free number of the Howie Carr Show. By the way, I would like to thank everybody who's been delivering gifts to me today. I felt like returning here. I felt like Alaric, the king of the Visigoths, entering Rome in AD 410, looting the place. There's so much great stuff in here. And I'd like to thank particularly Bob Maines. He sent us this from Matthews Brothers. He sent us a giant gift basket. I took all the crackers, and there was candy and nuts and all kinds of stuff. Thank you very much, Bob. And thanks to everybody at Matthews Brothers for that. Thanks to everybody else who sent us stuff. We got all kinds of great gifts. We appreciate it. 844-500-4242. I'm Howie Carr.
If you change the station, the Moonbats win. You're listening to The Howie Carr Show.
This hour of The Howie Carr Show is brought to you in part by The Howie Carr Show podcast. Did you miss any hours of our show? Go to Apple, Spotify, or wherever you get your podcasts and download any episode for free.
Come in and share the love.
Let your love give back. During the Subaru of New England Share the Love event. This holiday season, drive away in the brand new all-wheel drive 2020 Subaru Ascent. Starting at only $31,995. Or lease for only $299 per month for 36 months with $3,249 due at signing.
Come in and share the love.
For complete details and to find your authorized Subaru retailer, visit SubaruofNewEngland.com.
The reviews are in. Dirty Rats is a must listen. Dirty Rats tells the story of Whitey Bulger in a way you've never heard it before. It includes exclusive raw audio, chilling reenactments, and intense interviews with the families of Whitey's victims. Download Dirty Rats on your Apple Podcasts or Spotify, or go to DirtyRatsPodcast.com. Most importantly, subscribe to Dirty Rats on Apple and leave a review. It really helps. Binge Dirty Rats today. DirtyRatsPodcast.com.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Is Kennedy Babylon 2 your last book?
No, if I think of another topic for a book I want to write, I'll go for it. But I think it's the last of my Kennedy Babylon series. I made Kennedy Babylon 2 kind of long because I wanted to get everything in there. Now there's other stuff I could write about, but I'm Kennedy'd out.
Since having the sleeve operation, do you miss not eating big meals?
No, I don't. I can still eat what I used to eat. I just can't eat as much. I'm now very surprised how much I used to eat. I'm surprised at how much people I eat with consume. It's just hard to believe that I used to eat that much. But no, it's not a problem.
How is Mr. Gooner since Pearl's passing?
Mr. Gooner is drowning his sorrows in food.
What is the most trouble you ever got into as a kid?
My father was giving me grief one time up at Moosehead Lake in Maine, and I threw a rock at him. He didn't much like that. I'm here with Dr. Bruce Houghton from Perfect Smiles in Nashua, New Hampshire. You get a lot of patients, I'm sure, who are apprehensive about veneers. What are some of the questions and fears you get when you're dealing with new patients?
Some people think they could look too fake, but true cosmetic dentistry is incredibly detail-oriented. So we put a lot of time and effort into individualizing how the smile looks, and we really make them look natural but very, very pleasant.
You know, people are concerned. They wonder, you know, I got my teeth. Do I really want to put caps on?
Exactly. Yeah, they think they'll have that Hollywood look or fake look, but the technology that we have available and the artistry that we can create now really makes things so natural that most people, in fact, most dentists are just surprised that we can create what we can create nowadays. Everyone is different. Everyone has has different facial dimensions, different bone structure, and we do everything we can to individualize treatment because there is no one perfect smile. It is your perfect smile.
Dr. Houghton, where can people find you?
So you can find us at perfectsmiles.com or call 844-A-PERFECT-SMILE, 844-A-PERFECT-SMILE.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Who was your favorite actor?
Humphrey Bogart, no doubt about it. I love all the old Humphrey Bogart movies. Jimmy Cagney would be a close second.
Do you have a celebrity crush?
No celebrity crushes.
Ginger or Marianne?
I always was a Marianne person. Never was bowled over by that Hollywood look. Plus, Ginger was in more revealing attire, scantily clad.
Salty or sweet?
Neither, but if I have to pick, I'll go with sweet.
Movies or TV?
TV.
McDonald's or Burger King?
McDonald's, although I'd prefer Five Guys.
Facebook or Twitter?
Definitely Twitter. I hate Facebook.
Cake or pie?
I'm a cake guy.
Coke or Pepsi?
Diet Coke.
Coffee or tea?
Coffee, obviously.
Winter or summer?
Summer! Good Lord. Why would you want winter? It's cold and it's dark.
Hi, this is Cindy from Osterville, Massachusetts.
This is Brett Rock from Dunstable, Massachusetts.
This is Amy in Lisbon Falls, Maine, and this is the Howie Carr Show.
I think this morning Comey admitted he was wrong. Sometimes, Maria, it's better late than never, and sometimes it's just too damn late. And in this case, Comey is about 2 years too late. We could have used his objectivity. We could have used him as a head of the FBI helping Republicans figure out what was happening with FISA instead of thwarting us. And obstructing us.
Break-in spike every single year during the holidays. Fortunately, right now, Simply Safe is offering a huge discount on home security systems and a free security camera with your order. For a limited time, go to simplysafehowie.com to take advantage of this offer. simplysafehowie.com. Taylor, what's the poll question? What are the results thus far?
Who is shiftier, Adam Schiff or James Comey?
I thought about this. I'm going to vote for Comey because Comey is an unelected bureaucrat. I mean, Schiff is a slimy legislator, but he's only one of 435 or 535, depending on how you want to count it, slimy legislators. I mean, I'd say Comey is more dangerous. I'm voting for Comey.
38% say Comey is the shiftier of the two.
You may have prejudiced the answers by using the word shifty, you know, shifty, get it.
Comey
out.
Seemed pretty shifty in that interview.
Pretty shifty? Yeah. I mean, how about slithery? How about just, 844-500-4242. Someone said 207. Did you notice the resemblance between Schiff and the farmer from the American Gothic painting? Except the guy in the American Gothic painting is better looking. He's a more attractive figure. 844-500-4242. I wanted to play a couple more sound cuts here before we take some calls. Comey is now he's now gone from the "how dare you" defense, the Greta Thunberg defense, to the "what me." I know nothing. He's moved into he's Sergeant Schultz. He's Sergeant Schultz. Cut eight.
Did you know all of this?
All of what?
Everything that we're talking about here. Did you know that in fact the Steele report was the key for probable cause? Did you know that the FBI had talked to the Russian contact and he said what Steele said he had told him was not true? Did you know this? You're the FBI director.
First, again, the report will speak for itself. I don't believe the FBI concluded that Steele's reporting was bunk after talking to a subsource. But no, I didn't. As the director, you're not kept informed on the details of an investigation?
No, he just made it up. Some of it the guy told him was just drunk barroom talk, and then when that didn't go far enough, Steele just made stuff up. But other than that, it was totally corroborated.
as the director, you're not kept informed on the details of an investigation. So no, in general, I didn't know what they'd learned from the subsource. I didn't know the particulars of the investigation.
But this isn't some investigation, sir. This is an investigation of the campaign of the man who is the president of the United States. You've just been through a firestorm investigating Hillary Clinton. I would think if I were in your position, I would have been on that, you know, like a junkyard.
Like stink on you know what. Go ahead.
Dog, I would have wanted to know everything they were doing in investigating the Trump campaign.
Yeah, that's not the way it works, though. As a director sitting on top of an organization of 38,000 people, you can't run an investigation that's seven layers below you. You have to leave it to the career professionals.
Not four, five, six, seven layers. Seven layers before beneath them. But amazingly, a year ago, he knew that everything was on the level, that everything, you can't say kosher anymore. Can you say halal? Everything was halal in the investigation. Cut to.
Total confidence that the FISA process was followed and that the entire case was handled in a thoughtful, responsible way by DOJ and the FBI. I think the notion that FISA was abused here is nonsense.
How the hell do you know? That was seven layers below you. I'm Howie Carr.
It's been more than 2 years now since I had the sleeve procedure at Newton Wellesley Hospital's Weight Loss Center. I've kept the 100 pounds off and I'm so happy. I feel better and I look better. I just cleaned out my clothes closet, getting rid of all those XLs and even double XLs I know I'll never fit into again. Thank goodness. If you're thinking about finally losing all that extra weight, now is the time. Call Newton Wellesley Hospital's Weight Loss Center at 617-243-3724 or go to nwh.org/weightloss. I talked to so many people who've had the procedure and not one of them has ever said to me, Howie, I wish I'd waited a little longer to lose all this weight. Don't procrastinate any longer. Make 2019 the year you get your health back. Call 617-243-3724 or go to nwh.org/weightloss. Don't procrastinate any longer. Whatever your age, whatever your gender, do it. Call 617-243-3724 or go to nwh.org/weightloss.
Biden might be the front runner for the Democrats, but that isn't stopping him from serving up a whole lot of gaffes. Take a listen.
I believe that the president is literally an existential threat to America for three reasons. One, he is a genuine threat to our...
I had permission to hug Lonnie.
He says, let's make America great again. Let's make America America again.
I think I'm either low IQ or slow, or I don't know what I am. You know, slow Joe Biden.
The thanks for the Mary and I'm going to be here a lot.
I want the press to know she pulled me close. I just want you to know, okay?
President Trump inherited an economy from Obama Biden.
By the way, he gave me permission to touch him.
They can't even figure out how to deal with the fact that they have this great division between the China Sea and the mountains in the east, in the west.
Thank you, New England, for supporting Music Drives Us. Since 2006, we have used the power of music to benefit communities throughout the six states of New England. During this time, we've proudly supported more than 200 schools and donated upwards of 1,000 instruments. And this year, we're getting ready to donate all over again. Our work is made possible through your continued support of our musical mission. Whether you donated, volunteered at our events, attended our concerts, or engaged with us on social media, thank you. We hope you'll stay tuned with what we have in store for this year because it'll be our best year yet. Visit us at musicdrivesus.org. That's musicdrivesus.org. Or follow us at Music Drives Us on social. Together, we can keep music in our schools.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
If you could go back in time and give your younger self advice, what would you say?
Get a state job, because behind the job comes the pension.
What's the best advice anyone's ever given you?
Most advice is pretty forgettable.
What's the best money you've ever spent?
The investment I made to leave the corporate radio prison I was in. The worst people I ever worked for, no doubt about it. I'd probably be dead if I were still working for them.
If you were on a deserted island and you could only bring three things, what would you bring?
A radio, a Wi-Fi system, obviously, and a computer, and I would bring some books. Don't ask me which books, too hard a question.
What was your dad's job when you were growing up?
My dad worked as a resort hotel manager. He worked in Florida at the Breakers in the winter, and then he worked at the Mountain View House, as it was called then, in Whitefield, New Hampshire, and various other places.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Did you have any pets when you were younger?
I had a cat named Dexter. That was my first pet. And then I had possession of two poodles when I lived in Palm Beach, Princess and Frisky. They weren't really my dogs, but I took care of them. They lived with me. So they were my dogs. I loved those poodles.
When you were a kid, what was the best gift you ever received?
I got this wooden fort from FAO Schwartz in Palm Beach about the age of 6 or 7. 10 soldiers to go along with it. Such a cool fort. I had that fort for like maybe close to 10 years.
What is your all-time favorite movie?
Probably Goodfellas. I love Goodfellas. I love it even more than The Godfather.
What is your favorite dessert?
Oh, that's a tough one. Probably chocolate ice cream, followed by vanilla ice cream, followed by coffee ice cream.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
844-500-4242. We're going to do a lot of, we got VIPs in every day this week, and we also have some cheap bastard deals. So let's play the music. Lots of cheap bastard deals going on here. It's Howie Carr's here.
Bastard deal.
Oh yeah.
Sounds too good to be true.
Oh no, it's real and it's a steal.
You know there's plenty more when you shop at Howie's store for another Howie Carr cheap bastard deal.
Howie Carr, the cheapest bastard around.
All right. Well, you know how tough it is to get into Boston now. It's the traffic is a nightmare. There are all kinds of costs involved, and if you get a hotel room, they got all kinds of different taxes, the hotel motel tax, because it's only going to hit tourists, unless of course you live in the town and you have to rent a room for your in-laws or something. But anyway, so today our cheap bastard deal is with the Adams Pub and the Best Western Adams Inn Hotel and Waterfront Event Center in Quincy. And these are great gift certificates. You can use them for the pub, which is a great place. It's particularly great. You can save them for the summer but Paul Vacosa is here. He's the operations manager. He can explain to you what you get here. These are $125 gift certificates to the Adams Pub for $62.50. So that's a hell of a deal. That's a lot of meals at the Adams Pub. So, Paul, what do you offer at the Adams Pub and the Best Western?
Well, first of all, Howie, I'd like to say thank you very much for having me on. I've been listening to you since I was 13 years old. I'm 42 now. So
thanks for making me old.
And
I take it better than Jerry Williams used to take it. He would grimace and groan and moan.
Sir, I'd like to tell you that I'm a long time listener, long time call, and I'm proud to say that to you.
Thank you, Paul. So I appreciate that.
The Adams Inn's great place. It really is an iconic place if you're from the South Shore. And if you go away from the South Shore for any point in time and you come on back, there's two things you notice to let you know you're home. It's a National Grid tank, and it's the Adams inside because it's bright red right there. You can see it anywhere on 93. So it was built in 1961. It changed names before it became the Adams Inn, but we have 106 rooms. We got plenty of function space. We got a full service
And you can use the gift certificate for function space.
You could use
just
it,
use it
You could use it for that as well. We have a gazebo that's right on the Neponset River. We have everything from birthdays to weddings out there.
Yeah.
We also host.
And all the bodies have been dug up. Yes. So you don't have to worry about any kind of state police backhoes interrupting function.
When I started off at the Adams Inn, I was a maintenance manager, and I made sure, Howie, if you're not going to find any of that
it
stuff.
It put kind of a damper on the first debate of the 2000 election, you know, when they had to close those curtains. We don't want to see any skeletons coming up with it before the guy introduces whose brother put him there. Right. But that's all in the past now, right?
Paul? It's a different place, Howie. It looks fantastic. The pub offers typical American, American pub food, but there's two particular items that we have. One's the Mahdi. You're not going to find that anywhere in Quincy. One's the Aquarius sauce with the chicken tenders. Delicious. If you go on the Adams Pub Facebook page, you can see all of that stuff. And it really is a hidden gem. The sunset goes down. Like I said, we have the function rooms.
Yeah. And you got the Sam Adams draft.
Yes,
and
sir.
Yeah, that's where the Adamses are from. Or
in the Quincy, summer, we host an event on the right on the water on the gazebo that we have out there. And it's we have a local brewing company that comes out there. It's totally free to the public, live music. It's great. Yeah.
Howie, I've been to an event there at the gazebo, a graduation party, and I have to say, it is so beautiful. You really do feel like there's no way you're in Boston.
Right.
Or like you feel like you're at a resort or something. It has a very tropical, fun feel, and it's just like a really interesting place to be when you're on the water like that.
Right. And it's we're a long way from the summer now, but you can use these gift certificates anytime you want.
Yes, sir. They're good. They're good.
Come down for the playoffs, the Patriots playoffs, you know.
Plenty of locals that hang out there. So, you know, if you're traveling from a different place, you can really, it's right there. It's perfect.
Got a text there. I work with Paul's brother, Steve, at the T. Steve is a good boxer. Paul looks just like Steve. I did a double take.
Well, I'm an identical twin. So
I guess that's why. I guess.
Wow, that's funny. My brother does work for the T, so, you know, don't beat me up for that. But I applied. I failed the personality test. What are you going to do?
You have a good personality, Paul?
Apparently they didn't like it. Apparently they didn't like the personality.
Okay, so if you want to get these, these are $125 gift certificates. You can use it for a special event, for the Adams Pub, for a room, for anything. $125 gift certificates to anything down at the Best Western in Quincy for $62.50. That's half price, and that's a good Christmas gift too. It's $125 looks like you splurged.
Oh, you won't be disappointed.
Yeah,
you won't be disappointed.
Well, we're looking forward to it. Thank you for bringing in the food. I'm sure the VIPs are going to really enjoy the food too as well. So go to HowieCarrShow.com, click on store. And it's right up there, and just you can go to the, it's right there, and it's the cheap bastard deal, and we only have a limited number, and these go really fast. The closer they are into Boston, especially on the South Shore, they go very quickly. And so we really appreciate you coming in, Paul. And again, it's the Adams Pub, and that's the Adams Pub and the Best Western Adams Inn Hotel and Waterfront Event Center. And these gift certificates are good for anything at the venue.
Yes, sir.
Anything. Everything. That's great. Thank you, Paul.
Thank
we appreciate
you, sir.
It. And again, HowieCarrShow.com. Click on store, and it's right there, the cheap bastard deal of the day. And we'll open up the food for you guys as soon as we go to the next break. I'm looking forward to this, especially the chicken tenders. I'm a chicken tenders guy.
I created the sauce, by the way.
You did?
I did.
Give me a hint of what's in the
sauce. I can tell you off air, Howie.
Okay. Yeah, I don't want you to give away any trade secrets or anything like that.
The only reason why they keep me around, I offer pretty much nothing to them.
All right, I'm sure. Yeah, no, you're doing a great job. You're doing a great job. You're not going to get the pension your brother does, but you're going to have more fun.
That's okay. My ex-wife took most of what I had.
we're really going South Shore now. We're really going Quincy. All right. Okay, Paul. Thank you very much. We're gonna take some calls. But you can stick around till the break. 844-500-4242. Peter, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Peter.
Yeah, hey Howie.
Hi.
You know, I watched that whole thing first off.
I can't watch that. I can't watch those shows anymore. You know, I just watch the excerpts. It's too exasperating. I mean, just even seeing Schumer today, my blood pressure was going through the roof, him talking about a fair trial, you know?
No, I was talking about James Comey.
But I mean any of them, any of those. They're all the same to me, you know? They're all out to get Trump. Why don't they just bring ropes with them and, you know, and big ladles to be stirring the tar, you know, and feathers, you know, they're a lynch mob, a high tech lynch mob, as Clarence Thomas would say.
You better watch your microaggressions, bro.
Sorry, I'm quoting a black guy. Okay, I can that makes it all right. A high tech lynch mob. Wouldn't you agree, Peter?
Yeah, I agree, Howie. But there's one other thing. This whole thing is, I want to see these people taken down.
I do too, but we have to wait, Peter. I mean, again, you heard Barr last week. He says it's going to take Durham until the late spring or the early summer. I sure hope so. Thank you. Thanks. 844-500-4242. Uber Jason says it's easy to say you can't watch them anymore when you have a staff that you pay force to watch that for you. Look, Uber Jason, everybody, they watch it the same way I watch it, which is they get the greatest hits. You know, there are guys, what's his name, Ryan Saavedra or whatever his name is, he tweets them out. Saavedra. He tweets it out in perfect 20-second sound bites. I mean, it's a beautiful thing. Technology is wonderful. It's destroyed the newspaper industry. I'm very sad about that, but it's also made it a lot easier for me to be in radio. That's the way it is. Oh man, when I look back on those days, having to watch that crap for an hour or two every Sunday morning, and then draw straws, and whoever got the short straw had to watch it. And those people were more normal then too. 844-500-4242. Maybe it's connected, you know, the fact that they're so bad now because they know nobody's watching it all the way through. Bill, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Bill.
Hey, Howie, how you doing? I didn't know if you, I got an email last night that was late last night. I guess shifted a town hall meeting this weekend out in California, and it did not go so well.
Really?
And I watched it. It's on YouTube. And I don't know if you got a chance to watch it, but oh my God, there was about probably 10 protesters there, and they were laying into him, screaming. Next thing you know, everybody in the whole audience started going up in arms because they were all, you know, Democrats. And Schiff just stood there at the podium the whole time, did nothing. He just sat there with them beady eyes, and then they finally kicked everybody out of the meeting. But it was like, it was getting into fisticuffs and stuff there. They were going at it in the meeting. It was pretty good to watch, you know. They were screaming at him,
Bill, I generally believe in civility, but I mean, these guys are so uncivil. You know, they really do deserve a taste of their own medicine, don't they, Bill?
They do. Yeah, definitely. I mean, I think it's ridiculous that they've gotten away with as much as they have so far because I mean, if you went back, and I want to ask you this because you're a little older than I am. But if this would have happened back in, like, the 50s or the 60s...
It wouldn't have happened, Bill.
If it did, would there have been... I would think there would have been, like, a civil unrest, you know?
Yeah, but I don't think... You know, I don't think the Democrats would have ever attempted this, nor would the Republicans have attempted it against a Democrat president who hasn't done anything. I mean, that's what Trump's saying. Well, you know, why is this going on? I haven't done anything. It's totally ridiculous. 844-500-4242. And the thing is, you know, we talked last week about the similarities between the British election and what happened in 2016 here in the U.S. And did you see what happened the day after the British election? They had near riots in London. And these people were all, you know, they were all screaming and yelling. They lost the election 24 hours ago. And it wasn't like it was a close election. It wasn't like there were, there were missing ballot boxes. They got crushed. And so then they go out and they have near riots. It's like Antifa is out there. Resist racism, they were saying. And they were all white. Every single one. I know it's a white country, basically, but I mean, every single demonstrator was white, and they were talking about racism. And this was the night after I was watching it on the BBC, which is the left-wing thing. I wasn't on Sky, which is more, you know, Fox-like. And they were interviewing black people, Jewish people, Indian immigrants, and they were all saying, "I'm not voting Labor." They're promising all this free crap that they can't deliver. Not to mention the fact that they hate Jews. You know, they have no decency. I mean, and how Democrat-like is it? You know, I mean, it's just they're not going to learn any. The Democrats aren't going to learn anything. The only thing they'll learn. They stole that election, just like they stole our election. And then you got these fools saying they're going to steal the election again. What do you mean again? On MSNBC this week, they're talking about how Donald Trump's going to try to get a third term. Are you kidding me? We got sound cuts from it. We just haven't got to them yet. 844-500-4242. And again, get online to get your cheap bastard deal of the day to the Adams Pub. And the Best Western Adams Inn Hotel and Waterfront Event Center, $125 gift certificates for $62.50, a perfect Christmas gift. Paul, thanks for coming in. I look forward to having some of your food. I'm Howie Carr.
He's the maestro of microaggression. He's Howie Carr.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you in part by Orion Metal Exchange. For a free investing kit from Orion, text free kit to 484848. That's free kit to 484848.
Are you concerned about market volatility in this political and economic environment? Kevin Frisbee and the team from Frisbee and Associates can help you weather the ups and downs of the market, all while preserving assets and growing your portfolio. Call Kevin today for a no-cost one-hour financial consultation. 800-989-9100. As president of Frisbee and Associates, Kevin has been helping people just like you create a retirement and income plan to get you to and through retirement. We're experiencing the longest bull market in American history. Isn't it time to lock in your gains? In fact, what if you could lock in your gains and still be in a position to participate in gains without suffering losses if the market plunges? Schedule your free consultation now. 800-989-9100. You can also catch Kevin on the Howie Carr radio program every Thursday afternoon as he reviews the market and offers tips to a successful retirement. Call Kevin Frisbee today, 800-989-9100. That's 800-989-9100.
He's New England's talk radio king. He's Howie Carr.
The only French term I like is sans culotte, without trousers. I used to describe Ted Kennedy as sans culotte. Because after the O'Barr incident, when he was wandering around down on the beach with his 20th scotch tumbler of the day in his hand, stumbling around with an off. He was just there, as the Michelle Cassone, Patches Date, said. He was just there, without trousers. Or as we say in Paris, sans culotte.
We've seen nothing that we can work that I can work with President Bush on, and I'm disappointed because I thought that there might be some interest because of what he said in the campaign.
President Bush, this is your brain. This is your brain on Botox, okay? That's the lesson of that one.
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Would you say you're more like your mom or your dad?
No, I don't think I ended up being like either of them, now that I think about it. My mother worked hard, but she never really learned how to make a lot of money. And my father didn't work so hard, but he had a good personality. He was good with people. He was better than me with people. That's why I'm saying I'm not like either one of them, I don't think.
Did you have any siblings?
Yes, I have a brother, a younger brother.
What was your favorite subject in school?
Well, all kinds of history. I loved all kinds of history.
If you could have three houses, besides the ones you already have, anywhere in the world, where would they be?
I wouldn't mind having another house in Palm Beach on Clark Avenue. Maybe a place in southern Maine. I don't need a third place.
Didn't you already have a house in Maine?
I did. It was on an island. It was not a good fit for the mailroom manager.
I've heard the house was haunted. Is that true?
Yes. And my wife didn't really care that much for my relatives.
This is Kevin from Brockton.
This is Karen from Boiling Springs, South Carolina.
This is Officer Mark calling from beautiful Stratford County, New Hampshire. And this is the Howie Carr Show.
And of course, this is the last week the last few days to get your orders for the Howie Carr Show. Specials, the Deplorable Specials and the other specials, $19.99. Here it is, the Deplorables t-shirt. I'm holding it up now, proud to be a Deplorable, and it comes with What Really Happened, a $35 value for $19.99. Check out all that stuff, too. When you're going to get your cheap bastard deal, check out our specials at the HowieCarShow.com store. And $19.99 for all these great deals, book deals, and t-shirt deals. Charlie, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Charlie.
Yeah, Howie. I had the misfortune to have to witness Chuck the Schmuck talking about, among other things, how Trump wants wanted the investigation into Biden against his political rival, which, as far as I'm concerned, the investigation on Biden should be done because he misappropriated taxpayer dollars long ago,
right.
Just like when Slick Willie had his little fling with Monica. So
yeah. You know, Charlie, it came out over the weekend, too, that, Hunter Biden, he was arrested for drugs in New Jersey, back in 1988, at the same time that his father was promoting all of these draconian drug laws, changing the sentencing paradigms for crack cocaine as opposed to powder cocaine, and going after minority drug dealers as opposed to white drug dealers, white race drug dealers as opposed to powder. And it's just amazing that Biden has gotten away with all this stuff over the years. I mean, just everything. He just keeps making a fool out of himself on the campaign trail. Cut 42. Creepy.
You teachers who touched them, figuratively speaking. Well, I hope you touch them and tell them how much you love them, too. But my point is, when you touch their hearts.
Should he really be talking about teachers touching students? I mean, is that a place he wants to go? Is that a place any politician wants to go?
That's pretty much half of our Police Blotter Facts Friday stories, teachers touching students.
Oh, my God. Somebody stop him before he does it again. No, don't stop him. It makes for good radio. Arthur, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Arthur.
Thanks, Howie. You know, I honestly think that Trump is having a big good time over this whole impeachment thing, because there for all the world to see is what idiots these people are and what evil scum they are, too. Because I don't know why this hasn't gone to the Supreme Court, because that's where the Constitution is interpreted. And any time one of the branches steps out of line, that's check and balance. Is supposed to be applied.
They are evil. It's more they're evil than anything else, I think, Arthur. They're out of control. I'm Howie Carr.
Are you looking for a pre-owned car? Well, before you go to the dealership where you'll be pounced on by pushy salespeople, give the Car Guys a try. I'm Bill Papageorge, and my job is to make finding the perfect used car as easy as possible. That means I do all of the tough legwork for you. Once I figure out what you want out of a car, I go find it. I've been in this business for a long time, and I know what to look out for. I won't bring you a car unless I know it will meet or exceed your expectations. So give me a call at 800-300-4600. That is 800-300-4600.
Have you guys heard about my new podcast, Conversations with Grace? You know I love to chat, and now I'm chatting with some heavy hitters. I have already talked to the president's right-hand man, Corey Lewandowski.
You know, Grace, thank you for having me. It's an honor to be the first guest, so your ratings can only go up after this.
And of course, I had a legendary interview with Governor Paul LePage.
Thank you so much, Grace.
And don't worry, guys, more episodes are on the way. Go to HowieCarrShow.com, click podcasts, and click on Conversations with Grace. Binge it today.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
You are known as a cheap bastard. Which one of your daughters is the cheapest and why?
Charlotte is the cheapest, and I say that because she's always using my credit card. We keep changing the credit cards over and over again, and she keeps busting in and using them again. Most recently, just this week, she spent $75 at AT&T.
What's the cheapest thing you do now to save money?
The cheapest thing I do currently to save money, I guess, is I take all the bottles and cans back to the market basket every weekend. I always like to save that money. You know, I can't stand to throw those bottles and cans away and have the unclaimed returns go to the state of Massachusetts for illegal aliens.
Do you recycle?
Yes, I do recycle. When I got on the town meeting, I saw that the town dump was probably the only department in the town that was running in the black, and it's because of all the recycling that was going on, so I try to keep my taxes down that way.
Joe Biden might be running for president in 2020, so we should play some of his greatest hits.
Barack and I finally reduced the disparity in sentencing, which we've been fighting to eliminate, in crack cocaine versus powder cocaine. Correct. It was a big mistake when it was made. We thought, we were told by the experts that crack, you never go back.
You cannot go to a 7-Eleven or a Dunkin' Donuts unless you have a slight Indian accent.
If you want to protect yourself, get a double-barrel shotgun. If there's ever a problem, just walk out on the balcony, put that double-barrel shotgun, and fire two blasts.
They're going to put you all back in chains.
Give me a break. That's a bunch of malarkey.
The three-letter word, jobs. J-O-B-S, jobs.
One man stands ready to deliver change we desperately need. A man I'm proud to call my friend. A man who will be the next president of the United States, Barack America.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Show.
I'm here with Dr. Bruce Houghton from Perfect Smiles in Nashua, New Hampshire. Dr. Houghton, tell us about the state-of-the-art procedures that can help many people look 10 to 15 years younger.
As we age, we do lose these proper proportions to our faces. And so if you're deficient in your chin or mid-face, we can create the proper proportions and make you look great. Sometimes we use orthodontics to change the look of the face. Sometimes we just use the teeth themselves, and it creates the right support for a beautiful face. They're all non-surgical procedures.
There's some pretty complex cases that you deal with. Give me an example of a tough case.
Well, some cases is people just are missing a lot of teeth. I get a lot of people that come in and think that I cannot solve their problems because they're too great, but I really can. We've been doing this for over 35 years, and there isn't much that we haven't seen.
So even if you're missing a few teeth, or your teeth are discolored, or you're very embarrassed, there's no reason not to come in for a consultation, right?
Absolutely. New techniques, new technology, things are available to us that we never had before, and we can handle just about everything.
Where can people find you?
So you can find us at perfectsmiles.com or call 844-8 A Perfect Smile.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Can you remember any time in your life when you were starstruck?
One time I saw Peter Vesey, the NBA columnist for the New York Post. He was in the Herald sports department. I really liked his column, so I went up and introduced myself to him. Then one time there was Cousin Brucey from WABC, and I used to listen to him driving back and forth between Chapel Hill and Deerfield when I was in college. Everybody on the East Coast listened to him. I couldn't
couldn't believe that I was in the presence of Cousin Brucey.
Do you ever play bridge anymore?
No, I haven't played bridge in a very long time. Nobody I know plays bridge. I think my bridge days are behind me.
Do you think you'd still be good at it?
I'm not a great bidder, but I know how to count cards. That, to me, is the essence of playing a hand of bridge, is to be able to count cards.
What is a rhino?
Rhino is a Republican in name only. Think Paul Ryan. Oh, think Mitt Romney. Think Jeff Flake. And now, a minute of wisdom from Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez.
Millennials and people and, you know, Gen Z and all these folks that come after us are looking up and we're like, the world is going to end in 12 years if we don't address climate change. And your biggest issue is, your biggest issue is, how are we going to pay for it? And like, this is the war. This is our World War II.
I think that there's a lot of people more concerned about being precisely, factually, and semantically correct than about being morally right.
But being factually correct is important.
It's absolutely important.
And if we work our butts off to make sure that we take back all three chambers of Congress, all three chambers of government, the presidency, the Senate, and the House in 2020, we can't start working in 2020.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Show. And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
So now you've broken your elbow. Have you ever broken any other bones?
When I was 8 years old, I broke my leg. I was playing touch football in Portland, and a big kid, a 15-year-old, tackled me. When I was in my 30s, I was going down the stairs, and one of the kid's toys was on the stairs, and I tripped on it and broke my foot. I lost a tooth playing touch football when I was just out of Deerfield. I got smacked in the jaw. My tooth went up, and I still have a bridge, a crown, from that mishap. I have a replacement hip, and now I have a bunch of pins in my left elbow.
When do you plan to retire?
I don't plan on retiring. As an old football coach once said, once you retire, there's only one big moment left. You know what that is.
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Who do you consider the biggest rhino in the Republican Party?
Probably is Paul Ryan. I wish a Republican were still the speaker, but Paul Ryan was scarcely a Republican. And there was a reason he was Mitt Romney's running mate, because we had a rhino ticket in 2012.
Where did the expression, "How many more, Mr. Speaker? How many more?" come from?
That comes from the State House. There used to be a state rep who sometimes would talk about atrocities that were happening in crime. And he would get up there and he would say, "How many more, Mr. Speaker? How many more?" And I just picked it up.
Better strap yourself in. It's time for the Howie Carr Show.
Would you agree that the FISA court was also given false information by the FBI?
I think that's fair. I have total confidence that the FISA process was followed. I think the notion that FISA was abused here is nonsense.
Gross negligence. Or they intended to do it. They intended to lie to the FISA court.
As director, you are responsible for this. I was responsible for this, and if I were still there, I'd be doing what Chris Wray is doing, is figuring out, so how did this happen, and is it systemic?
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
Sometimes it's better late than never, and sometimes it's just too damn late. And in this case, Comey is about 2 years too late.
I was overconfident in those, because he's right. There was real sloppiness. 17 things that either should have been in the applications or at least discussed and characterized differently. It was not acceptable, and so he's right. I was wrong.
Who's your captain? Howie Carr.
Well, maybe it turns upon how we understand the word. Yeah, I think you're mischaracterizing both what the FBI knew and what Mr. Horowitz says in his report. I mean, there's a number of tricky things to that. Yeah, that's not the way it works, though.
Sniveling, obsequious poison of a human being.
But the American people, especially your viewers, need to realize they were given false information about the FBI. It's honest, it is not political, it is flawed.
Unchained and unstoppable.
On July 5th, 2016, at the end of James Comey's news conference where he exonerated Hillary Clinton in the email server scandal, I declared him to be a dirty cop. Nothing proved it more than his interview yesterday with Chris Wallace.
Rump swabs, hacks, and moon bats beware. It's Howie Carr.
There were certain elements of the applications for the FISA warrants that could have been characterized differently. Perhaps as lies, made up stuff, attempts to frame Carter Page and the guy he worked for.
Ugh. You know what drove me crazy about the interview with James Comey? Is that when it's a yes or no, like, did you do this wrong? His response is, I think that's fair. I think that's a fair criticism. No, like, stop doing that. It's this passive aggressive, I'm the victim. He gets this little voice on where everything is like patronizing almost. Yes, yes, I do think you could say that.
I just thought of something, how they're going to have to change criminal proceedings. To ask the defendant, how do you plead? Guilty, not guilty, or sloppy?
I think that's fair. Oh, drives me crazy.
Well, I'm back in Boston here for a week, and Grace and I are both on camera here now, so for a while. 844-500-4242. Bruce from the Mets say, how are you adjusting to returning from the beautiful people in Palm Beach to us losers? It's not the people I'm adjusting to, Bruce. It's the 80 degree temperature to tomorrow's snowstorm. And again, they may have to postpone the very important global warming press conference at the State House because of a snowstorm. Isn't that funny how that happens? And they say, some people say God doesn't have a sense of humor. He does. It's a wry sense of humor.
Actually, it's funny you should say that. I don't want to step on one of our Trump line messages, but some people think that you coming back from Florida and there being a snowstorm this next day is proof that there is a God. Because no one deserves a snowstorm more than Howie.
Maybe they're right. Maybe I haven't been living right, but I thought I had been. But anyway, what do you got for news, Grace?
I have so much news, but first I want to let people know that I do have a conversation with Grace out with Jim McKenna. He's a lawyer. We talk all about Annie Dukan and Sonia Farak. It's really great. I got a lot of good responses.
Those are
this weekend.
The chemists at the state health public health lab who were fudging and making up criminal analyses of drugs. And they were railroading all kinds of people who into prison with falsified evidence. I'm not going to say they were all innocent, but no one should go to prison on falsified evidence.
Right, and I'm just going to keep promoting it this week because I think everyone needs to know this story. It's crazy how many details you probably don't know. And I want to give a huge shout out, which I forgot to do Friday, to Matthews Brothers for sponsoring the podcast and giving me the opportunity to interview such interesting people. So I thank Matthews Brothers. We're wearing their gear today, and they sent us a lovely gift basket. So you can't get better than that.
That was an amazing gift
basket. That was a nice way to ease you back into New England. Was a massive basket full of snacks.
Yeah.
I was so excited when he saw that.
I had sent my daughter out. I said, when you come home tonight, I want you to get some stuff at the grocery store. And what was on the list was crackers, but now there's no more need for crackers or candy or cookies. Because I've got more than I can for my next three trips back to New England, to snowy New England. I've got enough stuff.
This is how we know Howie's happy about something. He keeps saying, this is excellent. And he must have said it 10 times in his office today, staring at the basket of snacks. Anyway, let's get to some Grace's news here. I got a lot of stuff I want to talk about, but I think I want to start with the Obama story of the day. Former President Barack Obama was at a private event in Singapore, according to BBC News.
He doesn't do public events. Because you don't get paid at public events.
Right. And people record them more and can use right. them against you in a court of law.
Right.
So here's the thing. He said this before, so it's not news, really. But I just find it so obnoxious. He said, Obama says women are pretty indisputably better than men.
Pretty indisputably. You're either pretty sure or it's indisputable.
He says
it can't be pretty indisputable. Did he read that on the piece of paper?
On the piece of paper. He says, now, woman, I just want you to know you are not perfect, but what I can say pretty indisputably is that you're better than us. He says that if a woman ran every nation in the world, there would be significant improvements across the board on just about everything.
Well, he's married.
Margaret Thatcher was pretty good. I think we can all agree on that.
But it's just so annoying because this isn't equality. Equality isn't men saying how bad men are and how great women are. Equality is just, listen, if everybody works well and does a good job, we'll be okay. I don't think men are inherently evil.
It's not equality, Grace. It's staying happily married. He has to make those statements.
I think it's just bowing to the mob because now he's getting a little pushback for telling them that they're being too PC. So now he's going around saying, women are better than men. Everybody knows that. It's just so lame. Get over it. Move on. Now, moving on to something else. I know you talked a lot about the impeachment, the bogus impeachment stuff, but the Senate Dems request impeachment testimony from Mick Mulvaney and John Bolton. Chuck Schumer wrote a letter last night.
Isn't this the same Chuck Schumer who said that there shouldn't be any witnesses in the Bill Clinton impeachment trial 20 years ago?
I think it's also the same Chuck Schumer who very memorably said that if Trump wants to mess with the FBI, the FBI has six ways
to Sunday. The intelligence community.
Yes, has six ways to Sunday to get back at you. That does not get played nearly enough.
Right.
That was a threat.
Right. Well, I think he was giving him advice and now about a lynch mob, and now he's grabbed a rope himself.
Yeah. Right. Oh, no, for sure. It's insanity. Yeah. It's complete insanity. And so I was kind of on the fence about whether or not they should drag it out, if the Republicans should really bring everybody in. And I've changed my mind.
No, I think if we had that poll question today, it would not be close. I think everybody would agree.
Finish it up. Wrap it up. Yeah. Because Trump just keeps piling on the wins, and this is just another way.
Again, think back. IG's reports clears FBI of bias. Totally the opposite in the mainstream media. Sondland, there's no quid pro quo. Mainstream media. There was quid pro quo. So you could imagine. So it doesn't matter what Mulvaney says, what Bolton says, what any of them say. It's going to be Trump is guilty.
Okay. And everybody knows here that I quote my dad all the time, but this is one of my dad's most famous quotes he used to tell me when I was younger. And I'd get in fights with people or, I didn't like a teacher or whatever. He would say, you can't beat crazy. And that's what we're dealing with at this point. We're dealing with derangement and the idea. And you know who actually said this really well? Tommy Lauren, when Megyn Kelly left Fox to go to NBC, she said she's falling for the trick of thinking she can get these people to like her. And the truth is they're always going to hate her because she's a Republican and they're never going to like you. So it doesn't matter if you do the best job and you're such a stately, kind, polite Lindsey Graham gets up there and says, we're going to give equal time. They're going to make you look bad every time because they hate us.
Right. And the thing is, too, I think Trump feels like, this is just sort of backfiring on them and this is going to be good for laughs. But on the other hand, at this point, he's now got the lead. So the important thing is to just win. You just win, baby. I know this is a bad time to be quoting
the late owner of the Oakland Raiders when they just got booed out of Oakland in their last game. But
Howie, you have a great point, because I was watching the Patriots game a few weeks ago. It was one of the games they won, but they had the ball and they did that thing where they run out the clock. They really didn't do anything. And Tom Brady was even talking to one of the refs or whatever, and, you know, making conversation. And someone I was with said, "This is wrong. They should play the game. This ruins the game." And I said, "It's not about your feelings or the morality or you wanting to watch a football game. It's about winning. It's about, if for Bill Belichick, it's not about, oh, everyone wants to see a good game. He wants to win." And that's how we have to think. It's like, yeah, it would be great to have that moment where Jim Jordan, or I guess it wouldn't be Jim Jordan, where Lindsey Graham rips someone apart. But is it,
or it could
put,
be one of the impeachment managers from the House, I guess, too. I guess you know, Jordan or Ratcliffe would probably be the one that they'd send over, because he's former prosecutor.
Yeah, Ratcliffe's really good.
Yeah.
But it doesn't matter. We just want to win at this point.
Right.
And I think that if anything is showing that this is backfiring, first of all, they all sound moronic. But the other thing is, they're passing stuff now that's good for Trump. That's how desperate they are. So it's like, you can't be in a more powerful position than when people, to save their own butts, start helping you.
Yeah.
That's pretty
good.
How
bad is it, too? You know, I don't know anything about this guy that quit from New Jersey. I've just seen him on TV a lot lately, Vaughn Drew or something. But, I mean, how
Jeff Van Drew.
Jeff Van Drew. How bad is it when a guy in your own party is so disgusted that he quits?
Yeah. And there was another guy, too, the Minnesota lawmaker,
he's
Democrat
an older guy.
Congressman Colin Peterson.
Yeah. Is he your congressman? No, he's not. We have a woman from one of the VIPs came in from Minnesota, Grace.
Oh, very good. Well, you should be proud of this guy nonetheless. He just said that it's completely backwards. They're trying to make a case. They started trying to find things to make a case. He said that's not how it's supposed to go. And like Lindsey Graham said...
No, Joseph Stalin says that is how it's supposed to go.
Oh, yeah. What does he say? Show me the man, I'll show you the crime?
Well, this guy said that, yeah.
Show me the Trump, I'll show you the impeachment articles. It's
right.
Like banana land. But when we get back, Howie... I have a lighter story that I think the VIPs are going to like. This is something I've never heard of before, but it involves a wedding invitation and Christmas.
844-500-4242. I'm Howie Carr.
Keep it here, chumps. More Howie Carr after this.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you in part by Orion Metal Exchange. For a free investing kit from Orion, text FREE KIT to 484848. That's FREE KIT to 484848.
We here at Matthews Brothers pride ourselves on listening to our customers and being sensitive to their needs and wants. Despite this otherwise positive predilection, every year we follow our hearts, take the road less traveled, and persist in singing Matthews carols.
Matthews Brothers is a sesquicentenarian.
That means we're real old,
but we're still flexing.
We've got a website.
It's wicked awesome.
We're on the Facebook,
just like your Grammy.
Won't you please friend us?
We also tweet.
Look for our stuff at
Better Lumber Yards
or our Window Pros.
And remember, Matthews has just one T.
All of us here at Matthews Brothers wish you and your loved ones peace, health, and prosperity, and may you have a wicked awesome 2020.
Matthews Brothers, Matthews Brothers, Matthews with one T. America's oldest window manufacturer are we.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
We went to the White House for the Christmas party. In your opinion, what was the highlight?
The highlight of my trip to the White House with Grace, there were two. Number one, when we walked into Trump International Hotel, which she'd been dreaming of going to, and her eyes were wide. And then when the president actually came down the stairs, her eyes were even wider. She was so in awe of being there. I really felt like King Farouk, you know? I felt like I was giving someone a really great gift that they couldn't get otherwise.
You've had some really good interviews over the years. Which one was your favorite?
I can't really say what the best interview I ever had, but one that just occurred to me was Jesse Helms, the senator from North Carolina. I interviewed him one time, and he went to high school with my mother in Monroe, North Carolina. And the first words out of his mouth were, "Howie, I know your mother before you knew your mother."
John, what happened at Perfect Smiles when you went?
The initial consultation was easy. In the past, they just hand me a clipboard to fill out the forms, but that's not how it worked at Perfect Smiles. What was nice was it was a true consultation. They asked me my medical history for what I wanted to get out of the treatment plan. For me, I lived with TMJ. I'd literally have to crack my jaw throughout the day to relieve the pressure. I'd get headaches throughout the day. I'd be in pain. When I was at Perfect Smiles, they asked me what I wanted to get out of the treatment. You know, as a joke, I just said, geez, I'd love you to be able to fix my TMJ. And I was surprised because Dr. Houghton specializes in working with patients like me that have TMJ.
What were the results of visiting Dr. Houghton at Perfect Smiles?
Not only did I walk out of that office with a perfect smile, but he fixed my TMJ. It was a life-changing event. People tell me now that my smile's amazing. People would say, geez, John, your teeth look so great. I never realized my teeth looked so bad before. Now I take a look at the before and after pictures, and I'm amazed.
Go to Perfect Smiles in Nashua, New Hampshire, or visit their website, perfectsmiles.com. I've seen a lot of anchor cupcakes in my day. Here are some of the latest network nitwits.
Tenney says, if I'm elected president, I will push for a constitutional amendment to impose term limits on all members of Congress. Correct me, there already are term limits, so what does he mean?
And what are we hearing in the background? Is that shelling?
No, Katie, you're actually hearing that from here in Jerusalem, and it's actually fireworks going off right behind me.
We're in our tribes, we're in our corners most of our lives. I think we just heard some gunshots. Should we listen to that for a second? Control room? Not gunshots? Okay.
Ivanka is not the second lady. She is actually, I don't think she deserves this position, she's actually a senior advisor to the president. So the idea that he would demean her specifically in that way, he shouldn't talk about the first lady that way. We aren't all here to make salads for men. It's disgusting.
I mean, I'm presuming he was talking about Karen Pence when he said second lady.
Oh, God, I'm sorry.
Not Montana. I'm talking about never mind.
Yeah, no, Chester,
I was getting Montana and North Dakota confused because, I don't know, I just was.
This is Deb in Danielson, Connecticut.
This is Greg in Boston, Mass.
This is Elizabeth in Wakefield, Massachusetts, and this is the Howie Carr Show.
Break-in spike every single year during the holidays. Fortunately, right now, Simply Safe is offering up a huge discount on home security systems and a free security camera for your order. For a limited time, go to simplysafehowie.com to take advantage of this offer. simplysafehowie.com. Taylor, what's the poll question? What are the results thus far?
Who's shiftier, Adam Schiff or James Comey?
Comey was more dangerous, I think, even than Schiff. As horrible as it is to have somebody that's that devious in that kind of position, I'm voting for Comey.
57% say Schiff is the shiftier of the two.
I think we just think that because Schiff has been more prominent in the last couple of weeks. But when you really think about Comey's job was to be impartial, and he really wasn't. Adam Schiff's a politician, right. So you give him a little slack.
By the way, there's some bad news today. Judge Emmett Sullivan has denied the motion by General Flynn's lawyer for Brady material, all the exculpatory evidence, and he scheduled the sentencing for January 28th. That's unfortunate.
I mean, no one's...
I thought they might throw the thing out.
Me too. And no one's gotten a worse shake at this than General Flynn. I mean, Talk about just... And he's an amazing, amazing veteran, and they don't give him anything, but if you try to criticize... I wrote a whole column on this. If you try to criticize Mueller, you are, you know...
Well, Venman. I mean, you can't attack Venman.
They get a shield.
He's a lieutenant colonel, you know, and this guy, you know.
It's crazy. Grace's News is brought to you by Moricello Blackberry Cello Liqueur. You guys know I love a tasty cocktail. I had a few this weekend. Whether you're having the perfect nightcap or adding a kick to your favorite Christmas dessert, you will love Moricello. It's available in any New Hampshire State Liquor Store or in Massachusetts at Total Wine, Busa Wine and Spirits, Blanchard's in West Roxbury and Jamaica Plain, Julio's in Westboro, the Corrid Pub in West Roxbury, and Fifth Avenue Liquors in Framingham. Okay, so I told everyone I would read this story, and I think it's really good. Bride-to-be slammed for trying to use wedding invitation as Christmas gift.
Is this a story about you?
No.
Well, you're a bride-to-be.
I know. It's like, I'm tacky, but I'm not that tacky. Come on, everybody. So this girl writes on Reddit. So you can write on Reddit, you know, advice for things. You can throw something out there. Apparently, people don't throw things out to their group of friends anymore. They go on the internet and say, like, what do you guys think about this? So she goes on the internet and says, you know, I was thinking I'm not inviting all my coworkers to my wedding. So rather than invite them all, I'm going to bring an invitation for White Elephant. And I'm going to have someone open it and then people can fight over.
Is that what they
over...
call Yankee Swap?
Yes.
Now?
Okay. Or Evil Santa, something like that.
What was wrong with Yankee Swap?
It was racist.
Name.
Okay. The Yankee.
White? About white, though? White Elephant?
You're right. We got to get on this. White privilege, White Elephant. It's too much. Anyway, though, so she writes about this and says, I'm going to put it in the Yankee Swap. And the responses back were amazing. Someone said, I can just see her bringing that as her White Elephant gift and everyone trying to pass it off as the gift no one wants. That thing is going to make the rounds.
Was it a destination wedding?
No. I don't believe so.
So oh, come on, that's so totally
you get
a gift.
So you get an invitation, Taylor, and then you have to come up with another gift.
It's totally
so you're,
a gift.
So it's
ready,
a two-for-one deal.
This is the comment that's going to... Her gift would be their gift for someone to buy her a gift
right.
and waste a Saturday in her entitled self.
That's not wasting a Saturday. That's an open bar. That's a free meal. That is a gift.
It's not a free meal. If you go to a wedding, you have to get a gift for like, what, $100, $150 if you're
you
a coworker?
You don't have to. Nobody's standing there checking to
are,
see if
are
everybody
you that
brought
desperate?
Gifts.
Taylor, are you that desperate for a free drink?
What lengths would you go? Look who's talking.
If I were that lucky...
The craft master here is trying to give me a lesson on how not to get free stuff.
I mean, I love a wedding, but they're a lot of work, especially if you're a girl. You got to get your hair done. You got to do your makeup. You got to get a dress. You got to get shoes. That's
you know,
my
the thing
gift.
Is, but the thing is, Taylor, you also got to put on a suit.
That's, so?
In the summer. A suit in the summer.
I mean,
who
so? That's a much bigger issue for Howie than it is for Taylor. Any sort of long pants for Howie is a problem. Anyway, though, this says...
We know. We have the pictures to prove it.
It says, if I were that lucky coworker that unwrapped the invitation, I would outright beg for others to steal it because I'd rather have the Billy the Singing Big Mouth Bass plaque than go to this narcissist wedding. It's
wow.
So true. Invite your friends and let it be.
You don't even have to show up for the ceremony. Just show up for the reception.
Yeah. You don't do that, Taylor, do you? You have to always go
no,
to the
I'd
ceremony.
No, I go to the ceremony and the reception, but come on, it's a gift.
Taylor's like a wedding crasher.
Uber Jason says, Schiff is crazy and it's obvious. Comey is sinister and it's obvious.
Yes.
Well put. That's why I voted for Comey.
Very true.
I'm Howie Carr. Break-in spike every single year during the holidays. That's why this time of year especially, you need Simply Safe. Simply Safe is comprehensive, professional home security at a fair price. And right now is the best time to get it. For the holidays, they're offering a huge discount on home security systems and a free security camera with your order. Go to SimplySafeHowie.com now to take advantage of this offer. It ends soon. That's SimplySafeHowie.com, SimplySafeHowie.com.
Are you looking for a pre-owned car? Well, before you go to the dealership where you'll be pounced on by pushy salespeople, give the Car Guys a try. I'm Bill Papageorge, and my job is to make finding the perfect used car as easy as possible. That means I do all of the tough legwork for you. Once I figure out what you want out of a car, I go find it. I've been in this business for a long time, and I know what to look out for. I won't bring you a car unless I know it will meet or exceed your expectations. So give me a call at 800-300-4600. That is 800-300-4600.
Jim Acosta, without a doubt, wins the competition for Trump's least favorite journalist of all time. Let's listen to some of their feistier moments.
I'll tell you what, CNN should be ashamed of itself having you working for them. You are a rude, terrible person. You shouldn't be working for CNN.
Well,
should I let him have
this,
a little bit more? What do you think, Peter?
Yeah? This,
Peter,
I
should
just,
I have a, let him have a little bit more?
This,
sit down. I'm changing it from fake news, though.
Doesn't that undermine...
Very fake news.
I know, but aren't you...
When I raise money... Excuse me. I've watched you on television. You're a real beauty. Honestly, I think you should let me run the country. You run CNN.
All right.
And if you did it well, your ratings
would
be
ask,
much better.
If I may ask one
enough.
Other question. Mr. President, if I may ask
Peter,
one other question, are you worried...
That's enough. That's
Mr.
enough.
Mr. President, what do you say to your critics who say that you're concocting a national emergency here in order to get your wall because you couldn't get it through other ways?
What do you think? Do you think I'm creating something? Ask these... incredible women who lost their daughters and their sons because your question is a very political question because you have an agenda. You're CNN. You're fake news.
I'm here with Dr. Bruce Houghton from Perfect Smiles in Nashua, New Hampshire. You get a lot of patients, I'm sure, who are apprehensive about veneers. What are some of the questions and fears you get when you're dealing with new patients?
Some people think they could look too fake, but true cosmetic dentistry is incredibly detail-oriented. So we put a lot of time and effort into individualizing how the smile looks, and we really make them look natural but very, very pleasant.
You know, people are concerned. They wonder, you know, I got my teeth. Do I really want to put caps on?
Exactly. Yeah, they think they'll have that Hollywood look or fake look, but the technology that we have available and the artistry that we can create now really makes things so natural that most people, in fact, most dentists are just surprised that we can create what we can create nowadays. Everyone is different. Everyone has different facial dimensions, different bone structure, and we do everything we can to individualize treatment because there is no one perfect smile. It is your perfect smile.
Dr. Houghton, where can people find you?
So you can find us at perfectsmiles.com or call 844-A-PERFECT-SMILE, 844-A-PERFECT-SMILE.
Bernie Sanders is officially in the race for 2020. Let's look back at some of the septuagenarian's greatest hits.
Should we give tax breaks to billionaires, which is what Trump wants, or demand that the wealthy and large corporations start paying their fair share of taxes?
Blah, 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 blah.
You know, it's funny. Sometimes American journalists talk about how bad a country is because people are lining up for food. That's a good thing. In other countries, people don't line up for food. The rich get the food and the poor starve to death.
We understand your wife has hired a lawyer to represent her in a possible probe into a land deal that fell apart. This was back when she was president of Burlington College.
No, it was not when she was. Okay, let me say a word on that. You know.
Yeah. Well, I just want to ask you. Do you know she's under FBI investigation?
Excuse me. My wife is about the most honest person I know.
At the end of the day, you don't necessarily need a choice of 23 underarm spray deodorants or 18 different pairs of sneakers.
People should not be dying in the United States of America when they are sick.
We will raise taxes.
We all love President Trump's off-the-cuff comments, but he's never in rarer form than when he's speaking at a rally. Take a listen.
I hit Pocahontas way too early. I thought she was gone. She's emerged from the ashes. And now it looks like she could beat Sleepy Joe. He's fallen asleep. He has no idea what the hell he's doing or saying.
I don't know. I'm not a vain person. But I look better under an incandescent light than these crazy lights that are beaming down on.
That guy's got a serious weight problem. Go home, start exercising. Got a bigger problem than I do. Now he goes home and his mom says, "What the hell have you just done?"
How do you top that? I'm just ready. The big, beautiful crescendo in this character's going back home.
One person just going home to mommy a little bit sooner.
Ah, these are phony people, but that's okay. You know, when you think of it, I'm president and they're not.
You really have to elect me. Whether you like me or not, it makes no difference because our country will go to hell if any of these people get in.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
844-500-4242. That is the toll-free number of the Howie Carr Show. As you know, I've been down in Florida for a while, and sometimes I go on other shows at night, and I ran into someone in the studio in West Palm Beach, and his name is Ned Ryan. And he really did a good job, and he was being asked about the impeachment proceedings in the House, and he said it's just become an early Festivus, an airing of grievances. And I thought, what a wonderful way to describe it. I wish I had thought of that line, so I just decided to steal it instead. But anyway, he's got a new book out, Ned Ryan, and it's called Restoring Our Republic, The Making of the Republic and How We Reclaim It Before It's Too Late. And it's a great Christmas gift. It just came out. And Ned, thanks for being with us here on the Howie Carr Show.
Yeah, no, absolutely, Howie. And it was, of course, a pleasure to meet you down in Palm Beach. And I give you full permission to steal that line. anytime you want to in the future, but it really did describe a lot of these frustrated bureaucrats. And this is one of the points in my book, actually, Howie, that, you know, these administrative state actors seem to think they're the ones making the decisions these days, when in fact that's not how a republic works. The duly elected president of the United States gets to set policy for both domestic and foreign policy inside of his administration. And what you saw with those hearings, people showing and grieving their grievances because they're so frustrated that Donald Trump has showed up in the town and said, that's not how this works. I know that people have ceded control to you, both Republicans and Democrats, but that's not how it works. And I'm here to tell you, I have a very distinct vision on how it's going to work moving forward. And that, I tell people, this is what we're experiencing the last 3 years. This tension has finally broken to the surface between administrative state governing philosophy and a constitutional republic. At some point, this was going to happen. Here we are.
Yeah, and you know, and again, I mentioned it earlier, it happened in the UK after the election on Thursday night. They had a near riot in London. I mean, these people, they're not even claiming the election was stolen. They just don't like the results. So they're out saying, we're going to resist. Wait a second. You live in a land that's run by a government that's established by popular control, and you're on the minority end of the vote. You have to bite your tongue. You're not allowed to have a riot because you lost.
Well, this is, I've made this point on TV as well and in some op-eds, that I think the left is finding democracy more and more inconvenient. You see that happening in D.C., that it's kind of one of those things, well, that's very nice, but we're the ones that make the decisions. And again, elections come and go, and these administrative state actors think, well, we're still here. And I've had them tell, I worked in the Bush White House. I was a writer for George W. Bush. Had a lot of friends that were political appointees during the Bush administration. And a couple of them told me stories where they were going in as political appointees into the various departments and dealing with career federal government employees who they're supposed to be enacting the vision of the Bush administration. And they said, nah, we don't think so. Or they're resisting it every step of the way. And basically telling the political appointees, we're going to still be here when you're gone. So basically administrations come and go, but we remain. So basically, no.
Well, that was what those State Department bureaucrats were saying. What's your complaint? He went outside the normal channels. Wait a second. He's the president of the United States. Whatever the channel is, that's the channel, right? As long as he's not breaking the law. He wasn't breaking any laws.
That's right. No. And I think but that's how it's worked for decades, Howie. Where the administrative state actors have been given so much authority, so much control, unelected, nameless bureaucrats, to make all of these decisions that all of a sudden, after decades and decades of having this control and setting up these, you know, their procedures, Donald Trump says, well, that's not how it works. You know, I'm sorry that's how you think it works, but it's not how it works. It's not how it was intended to work by our founders. And this is how it's going to work moving forward. And then you see all of this. But I tell everybody again, you know, the last 3 years, it really comes down to one issue. Who decides? Who decides? The duly elected president of the United States or these administrative actors who are unelected? And again, how it works in a constitutional republic, duly elected president decides.
You know, now, I mean, the Comey interview yesterday was just the latest example of it. But now they're basically claiming they're above the criminal justice system, too. You know, you don't get to plead guilty, not guilty, or sloppy. But that's what Comey was pleading yesterday. He was pleading sloppy. You know, so he can't be prosecuted. Just like he said about Hillary Clinton. Well, she didn't mean to break the law. Well, wait a second. The way the statute's written, it doesn't say what you had to have intent. It's just whether you broke the law or not. This guy is acting as the judge and the jury and the legislator who's writing the law all at the same time.
Yeah, no. I write about this in the opening chapter of the book that our founders had a vision back in the day of the divine, you know, right of kings, where the king was law. They decided that the law would be king, that all stood equal before it. And I think this is one of the problems that we're facing today. We have this bifurcated legal system where people like James Comey or Hillary Clinton, you know, if you have the right political connections or in the right position, somehow it's more a series of suggestions. But if you have the wrong political connections, you can have the book thrown at you and basically be sent to jail. And that's a problem for the republic. If we do not have equal application of the law and equal application of justice, I mean, at some point, that is when societies and cultures and republics start to fall apart, because people don't think that there actually is such a thing as the rule of law. And that's why I tell people there have to be serious consequences. This was not a mistake. I'm sorry, James Comey, let's be blunt. He was lying yesterday. And all these people that said, we didn't know about this, we had no idea what was taking place, oh, this was just a oopsies. No. It was very systematic. It was very intentional. It had one goal of undermining and hopefully, in their minds, taking out the duly elected president of the United States. This was systematic. This was not accidental.
Yeah, we're talking to Ned Ryan. He's the author of the new book, Restoring Our Republic, The Making of the Republic and How We Claim It Before It's Too Late. You know, the other thing, too, is it's intent. That's what they, you know, it's always, well, he didn't have intent. I didn't have intent to lie. Clapper, Brennan, they didn't intend to lie to Congress. They're asked direct questions. In the case of, I think, a Clapper, he was asked a direct question by a Democrat, Wyden from Oregon, and he lied to his face.
He perjured himself.
But yet now, these guys aren't in court. They're on TV commenting on these cable shows. They're not a guest. They're paid commentators on the crimes that they committed, not only committed but commissioned others to commit. It's just a very disturbing situation.
I mean, what this has exposed, Howie, is not only the corrupt administrative state, and again, Clapper, I have argued this, that until Clapper is held accountable for perjuring himself in front of Congress for the NSA and the spying that took place, you know, I haven't viewed him as a credible person for years. But this all goes back, and I think what we've seen over the last 3 years really highlights that a lot of people in the mainstream media and a lot of these various channels, they're not really so much news so much as they are propagandists. They really are. They are out there pushing a narrative.
Same with the New York Times. Truth. Same with the New York Times and the Washington Post. I just keep reading the IG's report and digging deeper into it and seeing how bad it was. And I keep thinking, at what point does somebody above my pay grade or your pay grade say to the New York Times and the Washington Post, don't you think you might want to give that Pulitzer Prize back for your deeply reported story about something that didn't occur? How could it be deeply reported if it didn't happen? So everything was made up. Everything was a hoax.
Yeah, I was invited by the Wall Street Journal to go to the White House Correspondents' Dinner last year, and I was sitting there watching CNN to a standing ovation, by the way, receive an award for their breaking the story that I think Clapper leaked to Jake Tapper and crew, about this whole Russian collusion fairy tale. And I just sat there, and again, in my seat, just going, what kind of madness is this? And it you know what it really was? Howie, in the opening chapter, I say that Washington, D.C. has a whiff of Versailles about it, that this ruling class and these people are so detached from the American people, it's like they're in an alternate universe. And that's where I got the line. I was sitting at the White House Correspondents' Dinner watching this take place going, dear God, this has a whiff of Versailles about it, that these people live in an alternate reality where this story that is not true, that was leaked to them by, I believe, truly believe, the former DNI, James Clapper, they get an award for that? This is insane. And I think the great thing that's taking place now is you're seeing Comey, you're seeing Schiff, you're seeing all these guys having to admit, oh, well, you know, it certainly wasn't truthful, but, you know, now they're making excuses. But at least it's coming to light that what we've gone through over the last 2 or 3 years, there was no factual evidence. And I said this, I go on other channels besides Fox News and Fox Business, and I remember telling Stephanie Ruhle to her face in May of 2017, there was no evidence, there is no evidence, there never will be evidence of any Russian collusion, because it's a fairy tale the left tells itself at night and hopes they wake up in the morning and Hillary Clinton is in the White House. She just about dropped out of her seat, but I'm right. I'm right, because anybody with a few brain cells and common sense knows what we've gone through. It's just a series of conspiracy theories used as the sinister pretenses to try and take out Donald Trump.
But think about it. You got the original document comes from Christopher Steele, who's paid for by Hillary Clinton, right?
Yep.
And then he gets fired, so he starts going to Bruce Orr.
Bruce Orr.
Whose wife works for Hillary Clinton. Bruce Orr gives the documents to Andrew McCabe, whose wife got $700,000 from Hillary Clinton's bundlers, and they start the FISA thing, and then they leak it to Jake Tapper, who used to work for Chelsea Clinton's mother-in-law. Could it be any more ridiculous than it? It's like a paperback novel, Gold Medal, you know, that was made into a black and white movie starring Broderick Crawford about some corrupt Southern town in the 1950s, isn't it? I mean, it's just, it's totally corrupt.
It is corrupt, and it's amazing to me. You mentioned Bruce Orr. I think he met with the – he passed along information to the FBI 13 times, if I remember correctly, after the FBI fired Christopher Steele. Mm-hmm. He was working as a conduit for Christopher Steele to pass on information
right.
still.
And they're both taking money from Hillary Clinton, or their families are. And by right. the way, Bruce Orr is also – he's tipping them off saying, by the way, this guy's out of his mind. Yeah. He's on the payroll and he's telling them that he's out of his mind. But you know, Andrew McCabe is lying to federal investigators and stuffing money in his pocket, basically, through his wife and the campaign. What does he care? His job is to take out Donald Trump.
That's right. No, and I tell people, and I'll say this again, you know, that our law enforcement and our surveillance state ultimately are based on one word, trust.
Yeah.
That trust has been shattered. The only way you get trust back in the FBI and the DOJ, and I would argue CIA, DNI, all of that.
Yeah, absolutely.
There have to be consequences. People have to go to jail. I'm sorry. People have to go to jail, have their security clearances permanently revoked, so that somebody in the future, if they get this bright idea that they're somehow going to take out the duly elected president of the United States, goes and looks at the consequences and goes, that wasn't such a great idea back then. I'm not going to risk everything to try and do this.
Right.
So, this is quite the time that we live in. But I'm optimistic. I think Democrats are going to impeach Trump, but I think he's going to go to a Senate trial. I think he's going to get acquitted. I hope that they go for a longer Senate trial so they can fully acquit him. And then we move on. He wins again in November of 2020. I think Republicans take the House back, keep the Senate, and off we go.
But again, the media is so corrupt. They're going to portray whatever the testimony is of Mulvaney at all. It's going to be portrayed as devastating for Trump. Oh. I want to see it over with. You know, fast gaveled. You know, directed verdict of acquittal, whatever you want to call it, summary judgment.
Yeah, I keep on going back to, and I wrote a piece for American Greatness over the weekend going, Donald Trump has had his due process denied him. He has been used. He's just been massively abused over the last 3 years. Give him his day in court. It doesn't have to be long. It could be, I'd actually argue Howie for 6 weeks, but it could be a little bit shorter. As long as you've got everybody coming in so that his team has the ability with them under oath on national television to ask them questions so that the American people can fully understand what was attempted against Donald Trump.
I think there was a poll came out today saying that people need. I think they said that the deep state, basically, they didn't call it the deep state, but that's what it meant. The deep state conspired to convict Donald mm-hmm. Trump of a felony. So a majority of people now have figured it out. You know,
I think they have. I want this to be very painful for the other side, Howie.
Yeah,
they have destabilized our democracy for years. And it's like some of them think they're going to walk away scot-free as though
they
nothing
do.
Happened. I'm like, that's not how it works.
Yeah. All right, Ned Ryan, what's the title of your book again? Give it to us.
Restoring Our Republic, The Making of the Republic, and How We Reclaim It Before It's Too Late. You guys can find it at Amazon.com. I, of course, am biased. I think it would make a tremendous Christmas gift going into 2020. It really will give people a vision for what they're fighting for in 2020.
That's right. I look forward to seeing you again, Ned. Thanks for being with us. We appreciate it. I'm sure it's a good, I haven't read it yet, but I'm sure it's a great book, and he's a smart guy. 844-500-4242. I'm Howie Carr.
He's the guru of graft. It's Howie Carr.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you in part by Orion Metal Exchange. For a free investing kit from Orion, text FREE KIT to 484848. That's FREE KIT to 484848. I'm here with Dr. Bruce Houghton from Perfect Smiles in Nashua, New Hampshire. Dr. Houghton, tell us about the state-of-the-art procedures that can help many people look 10 to 15 years younger.
As we age, we do lose these proper proportions to our faces. And so if you're deficient in your chin or mid-face, we can create the proper proportions and make you look great. Sometimes we use orthodontics to change the look of the face. Sometimes we just use the teeth themselves, and it creates the right support for a beautiful face. They're all non-surgical procedures.
There's some pretty complex cases that you deal with. Give me an example of a tough case.
Well, some cases. People just are missing a lot of teeth. I get a lot of people that come in and think that I cannot solve their problems because they're too great, but I really can. We've been doing this for over 35 years, and there isn't much that we haven't seen.
So even if you're missing a few teeth, or your teeth are discolored, or you're very embarrassed, there's no reason not to come in for a consultation, right?
Absolutely. New techniques, new technology, things are available to us that we never had before, and we can handle just about everything.
Where can people find you?
So you can find us at perfectsmiles.com or call 844-A Perfect Smile.
He is the youngest senator that is going to be running. In his video, he also mentioned he's the only senator that lives in the inner city, and he's an unmarried vegan. So a lot of very unique qualities Cory Booker brings to the table, Kate.
Now, I appreciate the comments of my colleagues. This is about the closest I'll probably ever have in my life to an I am Spartacus moment. I am Spartacus. I am Spartacus.
Joey, you like movies about gladiators?
Have you ever had an LGBTQ law clerk?
I've not been a judge, so I don't have any law clerks.
I'm sorry, working someone working for you?
I'm to be honest, I don't know the sexual orientation of my staff.
When Dick Durbin called me, I had tears of rage when I heard about this experience in that meeting. And for you not to feel that hurt, tears of rage, tears of rage.
Would you just stop being so dramatic?
I'm a big believer that if America, if this country hasn't broken your heart, then you don't love her enough.
Thank you, New England, for supporting Music Drives Us. Since 2006, we have used the power of music to benefit communities throughout the six states of New England. During this time, we've proudly supported more than 200 schools and donated upwards of 1,000 instruments. And this year, we're getting ready to donate all over again. Our work is made possible through your continued support of our musical mission. Whether you donated, volunteered at our events, attended our concerts, or engaged with us on social media, thank you. We hope you'll stay tuned with what we have in store for this year, because it'll be our best year yet. Visit us at musicdrivesus.org. That's musicdrivesus.org. Or follow us at Music Drives Us on social. Together, we can keep music in our schools.
Jim Acosta, without a doubt, wins the competition for Trump's least favorite journalist of all time. Let's listen to some of their feistier moments.
I'll tell you what, CNN should be ashamed of itself having you working for them. You are a rude, terrible person. You shouldn't be working for CNN. Should I let him have a little bit more? What do you think, Peter? Peter, should I have let him have a little bit more? Sit down. I'm changing it from fake news, though.
Doesn't that undermine...
Very fake news.
I know, but aren't you...
When I raise money... Excuse me. I've watched you on television. You're a real beauty.
Honestly, I think you should let me run the country. You run CNN.
All right.
And if you did it well, your ratings would be much better.
If I may ask one other question, Mr. President, are you worried...
That's enough.
Mr. President, what do you say to your critics who say that you're concocting a national emergency here in order to get your wall because you couldn't get it through other ways?
What do you think? Do you think I'm creating something? Ask these incredible women who lost their daughters and their sons, because your question is a very political question, because you have an agenda. You're CNN. You're fake news.
This is Paul in North Andover, Mass.
This is Luana in Lexington, Massachusetts.
This is Lauren in Augusta, Maine, and this is the Howie Carr Show.
He said it was a policy and procedure issue. It's not, Maria. They've always been policies against manufacturing evidence and withholding exculpatory evidence. That's not new. Those aren't new policies. This is a personnel issue. It's the wrong people in the wrong positions of power. That's not going to be fixed with a new policy or procedure. It's going to be fixed by replacing the people who did what they did in 2016.
You know, I don't think of it so much as Versailles, as Ned Ryan said. I think of it more as Imperial Rome. You know, it started out as a republic and slowly went out of control, became an empire. Then the empire became more and more decayed. You had the emperor was controlled by a Praetorian guard. That's what Bill Barr was talking about in one of his speeches in the summer. The attorney general, the Praetorian guard. They were supposed to protect the emperor, but in reality, they were the people who controlled everything. They thought they were the bosses. And it was downhill. And the other thing about it, about Imperial Rome is, Imperial Rome became just totally decadent, and they didn't produce anything. They didn't even produce soldiers. Everybody came from outside, and they were just sucking the life out of the provinces. You know, wine from Gaul, pottery from Anatolia, Turkey. Grain from North Africa. And I mean, it's just, and it was all going into support Rome, Just like now, what is it? The top seven out of the top 10 most affluent counties in the country are now in the Beltway. And it's all these people that don't produce anything. They're just bureaucrats. I mean, you know, there's nothing wrong with working for the government, but I mean, should they really be the wealthiest people in the society, which is what they are? Mark, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Mark.
Thank you, Howie. Merry Christmas to everyone.
Merry Christmas, Mark.
Thank you. I'd like to know if it's abuse of power to falsely accuse an innocent person of committing a crime that he did not commit. Specifically, Mr. Schiff, who lied for over 2.5 years, claiming he had irrefutable evidence about Russian collusion.
Right.
And now he made up a phone
and how about he denounced Devin Nunes's report on the FISA process, and now the Inspector General's report comes out. Nunes's report was 100% accurate. Schiff's report was 100% lies. I'm Howie Carr.
Come in and share the love.
Let your love give back during the Subaru of New England Share the Love event. This holiday season, drive away in the brand new all-wheel drive 2020 Subaru Forester, starting at only $24,495, or lease for only $259 per month for 36 months with $26.99 due at signing.
Come in and share the love.
For complete details and to find your authorized Subaru retailer, visit SubaruofNewEngland.com.
Hey, business owners and marketing professionals, would you like to advertise on the Howie Carr Radio Network? Howie's show reaches all across New England. And you know who's listening? Your next customer, client, or business lead. If you're interested in advertising on the Howie Carr Show, call 800-227-7300. That's 800-227-7300. You're listening to Howie, and so is your next customer. Call 800-227-7300 right now.
He is the youngest senator that is going to be running. In his video, he also mentioned he's the only senator that lives in the inner city, and he's an unmarried vegan. So a lot of very unique qualities Cory Booker brings to the table, Kate.
Now, I appreciate the comments of my colleagues. This is about the closest I'll probably ever have in my life to an I am Spartacus moment. I am Spartacus. I am Spartacus.
Joey, you like movies about gladiators?
Have you ever had an LGBTQ law clerk?
I've not been a judge, so I don't have any law clerks.
I'm someone working for you.
I'm to be honest, I don't know the sexual orientation of my staff.
When Dick Durbin called me, I had tears of rage when I heard about this experience in that meeting. And for you not to feel that hurt, tears of rage.
Would you just stop being so dramatic?
I'm a big believer that if America... if this country hasn't broken your heart, then you don't love her enough.
And now, some of my favorite fake Indian cuts of all time.
Oh, la, 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 la. I'm not going to ask you for your favorite curse word. Actually, I am. Do you have a favorite curse word?
Poop.
Poop? That's a goody two-shoes favorite curse word if I ever heard one.
Are you kidding? Have you ever seen a woman like me look you straight in the face after you finish some long explanation of something and then just said...
hold on a sec. I'm going to get me a beer.
I am not sure what she's talking about as far as a rally with...
It was a rally in Bern, is that you have to figure out who you are. I grew up in a family that was barely hanging on to the ragged edge of the middle class. And my Aunt B has walked by that picture at least 1,000 times, remarked that her father, my papa, had high cheekbones like all of the Indians did.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Show.
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300. And now, another minute of Madam Speaker Nancy Pelosi.
But, again, don't...
You have these wings, AOC and her group on one side.
That's like five people. They would say, play games, and then they'd say, open sesame. Except we don't say sesame, we say open Biden. But no, I because we are not. We have no, the number is growing. We have 91 women. There are 115 women in Congress, 116. 15 are Republican, 91 are Democrats. I happen to be a manifestation of the women power that is coming forth now, but only one manifestation. It was like getting kicked in the back by a mule constantly. It was physical. It was so unbelievable. The Times found Lincoln. Not to be presumptuous to put ourselves in those categories, but the Times have found us.
And now, 1 minute of Nancy Pelosi.
It is a bill that is much needed for our farmers and ranchers. I think there are only 47 votes against it in the House of Representatives. The American people should know the source of it. Again, we are engaged in the year-end continuing resolution, Homeland Security. I'm not sure. No, I haven't spoken to him since he called the other day, which was a very amicable conversation. Amiable, I guess you would say, not amicable. And I talked to Chuck last night to say, you know, we haven't had an answer. There are other things that are going on that are newsworthy, and I think I think you'd have more viewers or readers if it would address concerns that people have. The list goes on about the
You're listening to The Howie Carr Show.
All right. Thank you, New England, for supporting Music Drives Us. Since 2006, we have used the power of music to benefit communities throughout the six states of New England. During this time, we've proudly supported more than 200 schools and donated upwards of 1,000 instruments. And this year, we're getting ready to donate all over again. Our work is made possible through your continued support of our musical mission. Whether you donated, volunteered at our events, attended our concerts, or engaged with us on social media, thank you. We hope you'll stay tuned with what we have in store for this year, because it'll be our best year yet. Visit us at musicdrivesus.org. That's musicdrivesus.org. Or follow us at Music Drives Us on social. Together, we can keep music in our schools.
I'm here with Dr. Bruce Houghton from Perfect Smiles in Nashua, New Hampshire. Dr. Houghton, tell us about the state-of-the-art procedures that can help many people look 10 to 15 years younger.
As we age, we do lose these proper proportions to our faces. And so if you're deficient in your chin or mid-face, we can create the proper proportions and make you look great. Sometimes we use orthodontics to change the look of the face. Sometimes we just use the teeth themselves, and it creates the right support for a beautiful face. They're all non-surgical procedures.
There's some pretty complex cases that you deal with. Give me an example of a tough case.
Well, some cases is people just are missing a lot of teeth. I get a lot of people that come in and think that I cannot solve their problems because they're too great, but I really can. We've been doing this for over 35 years, and there isn't much that we haven't seen.
So even if you're missing a few teeth, or your teeth are discolored, or you're very embarrassed, there's no reason not to come in for a consultation, right?
Absolutely. New techniques, new technology, things are available to us that we never had before, and we can handle just about everything.
Where can people find you?
So you can find us at perfectsmiles.com or call 844-8 A Perfect Smile.
And now, some of my favorite fake Indian cuts of all time.
I'm not going to ask you for your favorite curse word. Actually, I am. Do you have a favorite curse word?
Poop.
Oh, that's a goody two-shoes favorite curse word if I ever heard one.
Are you kidding? Have you ever seen a woman like me look you straight in the face after you finish some long explanation of something and then just said, poop?
Hold on a sec. I'm going to get me a beer.
I am not sure what she's talking about as far as a rally with...
It was a rally in Bern, Orchid, by... is that you have to figure out...
Better strap yourself in. It's time for the Howie Carr Show.
Would you agree that the FISA court was also given false information by the FBI?
I think that's fair.
I have total confidence that the FISA process was followed. I think the notion that FISA was abused here is nonsense.
Gross negligence. Or they intended to do it. They intended to lie to the FISA court.
As director, you are responsible for this. I was responsible for this. And if I were still there, I'd be doing what Chris Wray is doing, is figuring out, so how did this happen? And is it systemic?
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
Sometimes it's better late than never, and sometimes it's just too damn late. And in this case, Comey is about 2 years too late.
I was overconfident in those, because he's right. There was real sloppiness. 17 things that either should have been in the applications or at least discussed and characterized differently. It was not acceptable. And so he's right. I was wrong.
Who's your captain? Captain Howie Carr.
Well, maybe it turns upon how we understand the word. Yeah, I think you're mischaracterizing both what the FBI knew and what Mr. Horowitz says in his report. I mean, there's a number of tricky things to that. Yeah, that's not the way it works, though.
Sniveling, obsequious poison of a human being.
But the American people, especially your viewers, need to realize they were given false information about the FBI. It's honest, it is not political, it is flawed.
Unchained and unstoppable.
On July 5th, 2016, at the end of James Comey's news conference where he exonerated Hillary Clinton in the email server scandal, I declared him to be a dirty cop. Nothing proved it more than his interview yesterday with Chris Wallace.
Rump swabs, hacks, and moon bats beware. It's Howie Carr.
Did you hear James Comey in the intro saying... If I were still there, I'd be doing exactly what Christopher Wray is doing. Case closed for firing Chris Wray. You're fired, Chris. Jim Comey would be doing exactly what you're doing. That's all we needed to know. 844-500-4242. That is the toll-free number of the Howie Carr Show. And by the way, we only have a handful of gift certificates left to the Adams Pub and to the Best Western Adams Inn Hotel and Waterfront Event Center in Quincy. These are $125 gift certificates for half price, $62.50. $125 for $62.50. Great Christmas gift. How was the food, guys? You like that, VIPs? VIPs like the food. It's excellent food. Thank you. Thank you. Go to HowieCarrShow.com and click on store, and you can get those, again, a great price. You give it to someone, $125 you spent on me. That's great. They don't have to know. They don't have to know how much you spent. All right. Time now for the Chump Line.
Forty Pelosi threats, 30 Schiff lies, 20 Nadler flubs, an impeachment that withers on the tree.
The Republicans are going to have a cover-up. They're not going to let us lie about them anymore. They're not going to let the mainstream media invent narratives that didn't occur, like Russian collusion, like... FBI exonerated, like there was quid pro quo, even though the witnesses say there was no quid pro quo. I wonder why the Republicans don't want to go along with this any longer.
Ira Mayor, I hear Harvey Weinstein ditched his walker as soon as his court hearing was over. And then who does he think he is? Ethel Kennedy?
Yes, Ethel Kennedy did that when her daughter, Carrie Kennedy, was being charged in, I believe, Westchester County for driving under the influence of drugs. She came up in a walker. But Senator Kennedy, the only reason he used the walker was he couldn't find your neck brace, the neck brace you and your son Patches used during your court embarrassments. All right, the Chump Line is brought to you every weekday by Matthews Brothers, America's oldest window manufacturer, saying that we've been deluged with requests to repeat the Howie Carr Matthews Brothers Charity Hour again this year, so we're proud to announce that Friday, December 20th, that's Friday, the last hour of the show, we're teaming up once more to each give $100 to the charities who call in during the last hour of the show. That's no malarkey.
You think Chris Wallace finds James Comey a very attractive man?
You know, Chris Wallace used to say that he found Mitt Romney a very attractive man, and he used to come on the show every Friday to talk about what was going to be on the show, and I just asked him about if he still felt Mitt Romney was a very attractive man so many times that he stopped coming on the show, because I don't think he found me a very attractive show host when I was asking him that kind of question. 727 says, most surprising thing about the interview with Comey was how many times he talked about people predicting he would go to jail, and this was some vindication. Going to jail has really been on his mind more than I thought. He knows this is the beginning of the heat he'll feel, though. I don't know how much fear he really has. He's so arrogant and he's so imperious, but an indictment is always a disappointment, as we used to say at Boston City Hall back in the old days. And a conviction is even a bigger disappointment.
Howie's back in Boston on Monday. And they're calling for snow on Tuesday. There is a God.
What did I do to deserve this, God? A snowstorm. Someone says, is Joe DiGenova going to be on today? No, he's on a plane. He'll be on Wednesday. We've got some sound cuts from him, which we'll play later on. He was on another radio talk show in Washington. We've got some sound cuts from it, and we'll have him on Wednesday.
First, we're going to impeach Trump. Then we're going to impeach Pence. Then we're going to make Nancy Pelosi president.
Here's a text. My name is Delilah. I'm 11 years old. I live in South Portland, and I love your show. Thank you, Delilah. If you want to text us, just text Howie to 63566, and you'll be in the text club. Some of the VIPs are asking about it, but we appreciate it. Always good to text in, and sometimes we read the texts on the air. A lot of the times we read the texts on the air.
James Comey is right about the seven layers. Seven layers of BS.
Yeah. Seven layers. He, you know, again, this is his new excuse. I know nothing. He's Sergeant Schultz now. Someone says, a month from tomorrow is your big birthday celebration. Have plans been made? I am awaiting my invitation. Well, I don't know if you'll be getting an invitation, but there will be a party, and it will be in Waltham. We've got a location picked out. It's going to be a really big birthday this year. On a Friday.
We're doing Secret Santa here at the office, and Howie's putting in his invitation as a gift.
That's true. That's true. And it's, what could be better than that?
Even if I get the invitation, I can't go. I've got to stay here.
I feel your pain, Taylor.
Don't lie to me.
Hey, Howie. Governor Patrick calling. I can't believe that Globe Puff piece about Bruce Mann and Elizabeth Warren's dog. I'm surprised they didn't call the dog Mann's best friend. We're going to be saying.
That would have been a good way to describe it. First, she buys the dog gets a puff piece. She opens new headquarters in Charlestown. How is Bailey the dog reacting to being at the new headquarters? Then they do a puff piece on her husband, Bruce Mann, and it's all about how Bailey gets along with Bruce Mann.
A beautiful dog, a talented dog.
You think they have a likability problem, the two-legged people in that family, that they have to just keep talking about Bailey the dog, who succeeded his predecessor, the late lamented Otis, the wonder dog?
Howie, I got caught speeding. I didn't mean to speed. I was just incompetent.
It was just sloppiness. That's all. You know, you say I was speeding. I would characterize it differently.
Yeah, is the FBI leadership corrupt or incompetent? I'm going to have to flip a coin on that one, Howie.
I mean, obviously, as we said last week during the poll, it's both. But it, you have to ask yourself, what's the predominant problem? And I'm going to say it's corruption.
Jim Comey found out when Obama did, when he read it in the newspaper like everybody else.
He read it on the piece of paper. It said you don't have to worry about the First Amendment, the Second Amendment, the Fourth Amendment, the Sixth Amendment. You don't have to worry about that stuff. It's just on the piece of paper.
Jim Comey, you're the director of the FBI. You have the most sensitive investigation in the history of the FBI, investigating a sitting president, and you're not getting briefed on a daily basis at a minimum. That's a tall tale from a tall guy.
Well, what did you want him to say? I can't recall. That's what he said to Congress 245 times, okay? He wanted to come up with something new. So this is his new thing. There were seven layers below me, and the lawyer making up the evidence, fabricating the evidence, obstructing justice, Kevin Kleinsmith, the little pajama boy with the goatee. You know what he called that? Oh, that business? That business?
Well, Howie, I guess we can start impeaching ham sandwiches now.
207 says the FBI is incompetent at being corrupt. Yeah, that's a whole nother aspect to it. I think the Keystone Cops could have done a better job. Or Barney Fife could have done a better job than the FBI did.
That was your last chump line message. Thank you for calling Howie Carr, you chump.
All right, that's it for the chump line today. The chump line is the recorded voicemail message service of the Howie Carr Show. You can call and leave a message at any hour of the day or night, including weekends. The chump line number, if you'd like to leave such a message, 844-500-4242, 844-500-4242. Press 2 for the Chump Line. Leave your message. We may or may not play it at this time each weekday. The Chump Line is brought to you by Matthews Brothers, America's oldest window manufacturer, saying we've been deluged with requests to repeat the Howie Carr Matthews Brothers Charity Hour again this year. So we're proud to announce that this Friday, December 20th, we're teaming up to each give $100 to charities who call into the show during the last hour. And that's no malarkey.
First, we're going to impeach Trump. Then we're going to impeach Pence. Then we're going to make Nancy Pelosi president.
Ah! All right. 844-500-4242. You've been hearing me talk about Super Beats for a while now, and I'm sure some of you are still thinking, why Super Beats? You could take it from me. The benefits of Super Beats are incredible. And my package finally arrived. I took these through the security last night, and I got it through. You guys, you VIPs are going to, everybody wants some Super Beats? Oh, yeah. Liquid? Yeah, they're going to have some Super Beats and they'll report on it later. It's really good. It gives you a boost of energy right away. The mailroom manager has started putting it in her smoothies, milkshake with the vitamins and the fruits and everything. She puts it in, turns it red, and she says it gives her a boost of energy. It's just great stuff. If all this doesn't convince you, we can talk about the science behind Super Beets. Beets have nitrates. Nitrates support better blood flow. Better blood flow equals better energy and efficiency throughout the body. It even supports healthy blood pressure. But Super Beets does so much more than eating regular beets and is unparalleled compared to other beet powders. I'm sure a lot of you didn't like beets when you were kids, right? Your parents tried to give them to you, didn't taste all that good. This is good. You're going to like this. This tastes good, and this is black cherry flavor. You're going to like it. Just one scoop of Super Beets has the nitric oxide equivalent of three whole beets. And the science team behind Super Beets has conducted 11 clinical trials and was even given the Science Award by the Nutrition Business Journal. This level of research is unheard of in the nutrition category. These are just some of the reasons why I love Super Beets and why it's worked so well for me and for Grace and for Taylor, and it's going to work for you guys, you VIPs. To try Superbeats risk-free for 90 days, visit www.superbeatsradio.com and get a free 30-day supply, free shipping, and free nitric oxide strips to test your nitric oxide levels with your first purchase. www.superbeatsradio.com/Howie. www.superbeatsradio.com/Howie. You're going to love it. I'm Howie Carr.
You can call him Fat Boy, just don't call him late for dinner. It's Howie Carr.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you today in part by the Conversations with Grace podcast. Hear Grace's compelling conversation with former Maine Governor Paul LePage. Never before heard stories and political news too. All at HowieCarrShow.com.
You might hear a lot about Bernie, Biden, and Elizabeth Warren, but what about the lightweights who are running for president? Here's a best of the B team.
I've listened to some of my colleagues, Mr. Glover, tell you how much they like your movies. And I have to say, we didn't come here to talk about your movies. We came here to talk about your activism. I like your activism. I also like your movies, but I want to give you a chance because I haven't heard the other side other than tell you that they like your movies.
I think the NRA is the worst organization in this country for doing exactly that. They care more about the profits than the American people.
I learned a long time ago about polling. It's not where you start, it's where you finish. I mean, right now, I got nowhere to go but up.
Millions living in the shadows, working some of the toughest jobs, kept in modern-day bondage.
People commit crime. Crime happens.
I have won every single congressional district in my state, including Michelle Bachmann's, okay? That's when you guys are supposed to cheer.
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours, too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
And now, 1 minute of Nancy Pelosi.
It is a bill that is much needed for our farmers and ranchers. I think there are only 47 votes against it in the House of Representatives. The American people should know the source of it. Again, we are engaged in the year-end continuing resolution, Homeland Security. I'm not sure. No, I haven't spoken to him since he called the other day, which was a very amicable conversation. Amiable, I guess you would say, not amicable. And I talked to Chuck last night to say, you know, we haven't had an answer. There are other things that are going on that are newsworthy, and I think I think you'd have more viewers or readers if it addressed concerns that people have. The list goes on about the
This is Lynn in sunny Las Vegas.
This is Dan from the Moonbat capital of Jamaica Plain.
This is Gigi in Leominster, Massachusetts, and this is the Howie Carr Show.
844-500-4242. That's the toll-free number of the Howie Carr Show. Jay from Chelsea complains. I read most of the texts on the air. That was what I just said. You haven't read one of mine since well before Thanksgiving. Come on, Jay. Jay's okay. Jay wants me to talk about the Oakland Raiders game, about how they should boo Schiff and Comey like the Oakland Raiders fans did. You know what? The Raiders, as pathetic as that game was yesterday, they've had a better year than Schiff and Comey, I think. Definitely. Those guys are more in the Cincinnati Bengals, New York Giants territory, the way things are going. And they just keep they just keep piling on. Anyway, now it's time for the poll question of the day. Break-ins spike every single year during the holidays. Fortunately, right now, Simply Safe is offering up a huge discount on home security systems and a free security camera with your order. For a limited time, go to simplysafehowie.com to take advantage of this offer. simplysafehowie.com. Taylor, what's the poll question? What are the results thus far?
Who's shiftier, Adam Schiff or James Comey?
Comey. I'm sticking with Comey. He's sinister, whereas Schiff is insane.
46% say James Comey is shifty.
Oh, shiftier. Okay. Shiftier. Okay. 844-500-4242. Play cut one here, where he at least Comey admits to something.
Would you agree that the FISA court was also given false information by the FBI?
I think that's fair. The FBI should have included, or at least pushed to the lawyers so they could make a decision.
That's fair. Yes, they lied. They put not into a sentence about whether Carter Page was a source, a credible source. 844-500-4242. And then again, he said it was just a business. It was just, it was just business that, Kleinsmith, the crooked FBI lawyer, obstructed justice. Let's play cut Joe DiGenova on that. Cut 21.
Kleinsmith changed a document from the CIA, which said that Carter Page was in fact an asset of theirs who worked with them and he was credible. Kleinsmith, an FBI lawyer, mind you, lawyer, changed that email to say that Carter Page was not an asset of the CIA. Comey says that's a nothing burger. James Comey is a very sick man. Sick, sick, sick.
How can they say there was no bias? You can't make a mistake like that. That's not a mistake. You have to deliberately want to do that, and you want to continue. The reason he did it was so he could continue the charade of surveilling, wiretapping, whatever verb you want to use, Carter Page, hoping you're going to turn up something on the president of the United States. It was insane, and it was a crime. Johnny, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Johnny.
Howie, I think we just want to be careful not to underestimate the political genius of Donald Trump. I think this week is going to play out exactly like he wants. It's going to be a short trial, but it's also going to leave the impression to the American people that he is willing to fight for what he believes in and that he has all the evidence on his side and that this is, as he says, just a scam and a hoax. And I think the public perception is going to be totally in his favor after this is over, and that's going to be done in a very short time.
I hope it's done in an extremely short amount of time. I get the feeling the last couple of times he's spoken to the press that he was kind of leaning towards taking McConnell and Graham's advice. Thanks for the call. I'm Howie Carr. I'm here with Dr. Bruce Houghton from Perfect Smiles in Nashua, New Hampshire. You get a lot of patients, I'm sure, who are apprehensive about veneers. What are some of the questions and fears you get when you're dealing with new patients?
Some people think they could look too fake, but true cosmetic dentistry is incredibly detail-oriented. So we put a lot of time and effort into individualizing how the smile looks, and we really make them look natural but very, very pleasant.
You know, people are concerned. They wonder, I got my teeth. Do I really want to put caps on?
Exactly. Yeah, they think they'll have that Hollywood look or fake look, but the technology that we have available and the artistry that we can create now really makes things so natural that most people, in fact, most dentists are just surprised that we can create what we can create nowadays. Everyone is different. Everyone has different facial dimensions, different bone structure, and we do everything we can to individualize treatment because there is no one perfect smile. It is your perfect smile.
Dr. Houghton, where can people find you?
So you can find us at perfectsmiles.com or call 844-A-PERFECT-SMILE, 844-A-PERFECT-SMILE.
There are plenty of differences between Trump and the Democrats running for 2020, but the main one is Trump's pretty funny. Take a listen.
What advice would you give to the 25-year-old Donald Trump knowing what you know today?
Don't run for president.
I'm not a drinker. I can honestly say I never had a beer in my life, okay? It's one of my only good traits. I don't drink. Whenever they're looking for something good, I say, I never had a glass of alcohol. I've never had alcohol. Can you imagine if I had? What a mess I'd be? Would I be the, I'd be the world's worst. Other countries, big countries, India and others, we had to pay because they considered them a growing country. They were a growing country. I said, what are we? Are we allowed to grow too? Okay. No, are we allowed to grow?
I try like hell to hide that bald spot, folks. I work harder. Doesn't look bad. Hey, we're hanging in.
I should have saved the Pocahontas thing for another year. Because I've destroyed her political career, and now I won't get a chance to run against her, and I would have loved it. I don't want to knock out all of the good stuff and end up with somebody that's actually got talent. That would be terrible.
John, what happened at Perfect Smiles when you went?
The initial consultation was easy. In the past, they just hand me a clipboard, they fill out the forms, but that's not how I worked at Perfect Smiles. What was nice was it was a true consultation. They asked me my medical history for what I wanted to get out of the treatment plan. For me, I lived with TMJ. I'd literally have to crack my jaw throughout the day to relieve the pressure. I'd get headaches throughout the day. I'd be in pain. When I was at Perfect Smiles, they asked me what I wanted to get out of the treatment. You know, as a joke, I just said, geez, I'd love you to be able to fix my TMJ. And I was surprised because Dr. Houghton specializes in working with patients like me that have TMJ.
What were the results of visiting Dr. Houghton at Perfect Smiles?
Not only did I walk out of that office with a perfect smile, but he fixed my TMJ. It was a life-changing event. People tell me now that my smile is amazing. People would say, geez, John, your teeth look so great. I never realized my teeth looked so bad before. Now I take a look at the before and after pictures, and I'm amazed.
Go to Perfect Smiles in Nashua, New Hampshire, or visit their website, perfectsmiles.com.
Brace yourself, guys. Here's 1 minute of Nancy Pelosi.
I myself have always been for lowering the voting age to 16. I think it's really important to capture kids when they're in high school, which was a very amiable conversation, I guess you would say, not amicable.
That they wanted their voices to be heard.
I don't think our colleague is anti-Semitic. I think she has a different experience in the use of words. That's not the total package, but they are some of the major points of discussion, I would hope, from sea to shining sea, because they are not getting paid Republicans voted no. Wisdom from the kitchen of the Willard Hotel, yes, ma'am.
The president either doesn't know what he's talking about or doesn't want to know what he's talking about.
You can call him Fat Boy, just don't call him late for dinner. He's Howie Carr.
We will bring over your entire family from the third world Muslim hellhole that they live in so that they can have an all expenses paid, taxpayer funded with open bar weekend at a nice hotel in Boston, get a nice sightseeing tour, maybe take them to Fenway Park for a game so they can see their savage Muslim terrorist kinsman sentenced to death. But the president of the United States of America can't be allowed to speak before Parliament because he's such a terrible barbarian, as opposed to the dictator of Red China. And I'm going to call it Red China. Since the Dems are down on Russia, we might as well go after all the communist dictatorships that are left, right? Russia isn't even a communist dictatorship. It's just authoritarian now. But let's call it Red China.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
844-500-4242. How is the Super Beats, guys? You like it? Good? Good stuff? There it is. Salud. All right. 844-500-4242. Let's play one. We're going to go back to the phones, but I want to play one more cut with Comey squirming when Wallace is asking him about the FBI. Famous but incompetent. Misleading the FISA court. Cut three.
Gross negligence, or they intended to do it. They intended to lie to the FISA court. You were in charge during a lot of this, sir. Yeah, and in fact, you signed the FISA applications.
Sure, I think I signed at least two or three of them. He doesn't conclude that there was intentional misconduct by these career special agents.
No, he just says it's one of two things and he can't decide. Gross negligence or it was intentional misconduct. Well, that's what he said.
I've read his report. He says we are not concluding that there was intentional misconduct by FBI.
Did you hear what he just said here?
I did. I don't know the context of that. I've read.
He was asked specifically, how do you explain it? And he said gross negligence or intentionality.
Yeah, well, I'm sorry, he doesn't find intentionality, but that doesn't make it any less important. As director, you are responsible for this. I was responsible for this, and if I were still there, I'd be doing what Chris Wray is doing, is figuring out, so how did this happen, and is it systemic?
Is it systemic? How far back do you want to go? Okay, how about we start in 1965 when they framed the guys in Boston, just for starters? Is it systemic? And you like the way he says too, it was career special agents. You know, like somehow that makes it better. So wait a second. So if you're shot by a career hitman, does that make it any less of a crime than if you're just shot by somebody out on the street? I mean, what's the difference? If you're a criminal, you're a damn criminal. Career special agents. And by the way, how special are they? I always like that. I'm a special agent for the FBI. Well, let me be the judge of whether you're special or not. 844-500-4242. I'm a special talk show host, okay? That's what I'm going to call myself, a special.
Or talk show host.
A career talk show. Or how about this? I'm a decorated talk show host. They ever run into an FBI agent who wasn't a decorated FBI agent? It's kind of like an Emmy award-winning TV reporter. They're Emmy nominated. Everybody's been nominated. Even I was once nominated for an Emmy award. You know, I mean, there's nobody who hasn't been nominated. Or there's no such thing as a reporter for a newspaper that isn't an award-winning.
If ever you go before Congress and they say, "Mr. Carr," you can say, "Mr. Chairman, please, it's Radio Hall of Famer."
Yeah.
Specialist career talk show host, Carr. Thank you.
Dr. Carr. If Jill Biden can be a doctor, I can be a doctor. If Christine Blasey Ford can be a doctor, I can be a doctor. And, I didn't bring my script pad with me. Sorry, I can't write out any scripts for anybody. I'll get back to you on that one. Jim, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Jim.
Yeah, hi, Howie. Thanks for taking my call. If this impeachment goes on, will your daughter lose her hack job?
She doesn't have a hack job anymore. She worked in the administration, but she's been out of the administration for over a year, Jim.
She get paid.
Excuse me?
How much did she get paid, and was there a nationwide search for her?
There was a nationwide search. Yeah, she was hired by the her employer down in Dallas, who was a big fundraiser for the Republican Party. So yes, but she's out of the administration, and I don't think she will ever be going back to the public sector. I'm very glad that she's outside the Beltway. Thanks for the call, Jim. Cindy, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Cindy.
Oh, hi, Howie. You know, I listened to the Chris Wallace interview, and I quit watching Fox because of him and Judge Napolitano. But anyways, the problem is the people that are, I still watch a little bit of Fox, but they come on and they say stuff like, he's to be applauded for trying to blame the people below him for everything.
Who said he was to be applauded? I didn't hear him say he was anyone.
That was on one of the Fox.
He picked out the venue because he figured that, you know, I mean, Wallace did a decent job, but Wallace was going to be easier on him than anybody else. That's for sure. I think that's why he wanted. I mean, again, what does it tell Wallace that both Comey and Schiff decided that they wanted to be on his show? Why was that? Because Shep Smith isn't available anymore, Cindy, right?
Exactly. Well, he was another one, and I was glad when he left. But, I mean, there are certain people I do watch on Fox, but some people, they just when they're interviewing the Democratic people, they let them get away with lies. I listen to the hearings, and they let them get away with lies talking, and it just drives me crazy because I actually heard what they said. They allow the Democrats when they come on their shows to lie. And so anyway,
Cindy, stick with Newsmax. You know, stick with the other channels if you can't stand the big dog in the field, because we're pretty much. We're not going to take any BS from these people. That's for sure. And the other thing that bugs me about some of these stations is, I used to run into it when I went on some of the other channels, is that you go on there and it's three against one. Everything is, it's not the host is against you, and then they have two other people on, and everybody's yelling at the one guy who's trying to defend Donald Trump. And again, as we talked about earlier, it's the same whether it's in the deep state or on TV, which I guess is, or the media, which is the same thing nowadays. It's all about intent. You know, the Democrats always get a pass. Oh, they didn't mean to do anything, or it was sloppiness. Whereas if Comey got nailed for some kind of income tax problem, he'd use the S word again, sloppiness, right? But they're trying to get the Trump's tax returns so that they can say he committed some kind of income tax evasion. 844-500-4242. Look at the last three speakers in the Massachusetts House, other than the unindicted co-conspirator who was now there. I mean, you have one of them went down on income tax evasion, sloppiness, right? Obstruction of justice, sloppiness. And the last one, DeMacy, went down on an extortion rap. I guess he didn't realize that you're not supposed to demand a payoff from somebody you're giving a software contract to, right? He had no intent to extort money. You know, I mean, if you want to use these excuses, you can use them for anything. 844-500-4242. Steve, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Steve.
Hey, Howie. Whatever happened to the slogan, ignorance of the law is no excuse?
That's a really good point. I grew up listening to that on TV, radio, and the newspapers. You never hear it anymore, though, do you? You know, I'll tell you another thing you never see anymore, Steve. Blind justice. Remember blind justice with the blindfold over her head? And she's got, justice is no longer blind. Justice had all the cataracts have been removed from her eyes, right? She knows Republican guilty, Democrat, no intent, move along, right?
Yeah. Oh yeah, absolutely. And the other thing too is, I don't give a damn if a murderer had happy thoughts and he didn't mean anything by it. You're supposed to be convicted by your actions. To this whole idea that we have to become psychoanalysts and then figure out the psychology of the perpetrator is a bunch of crap.
Right. I think some of the Democrats were saying last week, weren't they? Well, it doesn't matter what Trump said because we know what he was thinking. How does, even if you're married to somebody or even if it's your kid, we had a guy in here who has an identical twin. You don't know what your identical twin is thinking, let alone anybody else, That's why you have to be convicted by what you do, not by what you were thinking, because nobody knows what you're thinking, right?
Yeah.
And yet they're up there in Congress. Supposedly the lawmakers for the whole nation, and they're talking about they want to get rid of a president because they think they know what he was thinking. It's really a sad state of affairs when it's one thing to even think this stuff, let alone say it out loud, that you think somebody should be impeached because of what you think they were thinking. And I don't even think they believe what they're saying. They're just saying what they think is going to go over with their low information voters. Thanks for the call, Steve. Joe, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Joe.
Hey, Howie, one interesting point that it's kind of, I think, is getting overlooked. The FBI went back three times between January and May of 2017 and interviewed Steele Subsource.
Yes.
Right? Well, I'd love to compare those 302s. Why do they keep going back? And the first time, apparently that source hasn't changed his story. And he did change his story. Now he's become unreliable. But were they going back to pressure him? And that wasn't reported up the chain that, the source, we're going back
well,
again.
Well,
we're
how
going
about,
back again.
Joe, how about first the, you know, at he, the subsource said, well, I told him that, but that was just barroom talk. And then they said to him in at least two or three instances, well, for instance, he said on the P tapes, he said that was confirmed by Russian intelligence. Did you tell him it was confirmed by Russian intelligence? And he said, I never told him that. So he was passing on barroom talk about the P, and then Steele just made up the stuff about it being confirmed. So it was a combination of hearsay and total fabrication. But guess what? What did Steele care? The checks were clearing from Hillary Clinton. And then when the FBI fired him, he just passed it on through Bruce Orr, whose wife was also working for Fusion GPS, which was being paid for by the Clintons. And they delivered the material to Andrew McCabe. I keep going over this because I don't think anybody else talks about it. Andrew McCabe, whose wife got $700,000 from Clinton's governor of Virginia. And then when they decided that they wanted to put it out into the media, they gave it to Jake Tapper, who used to be the flack for Chelsea Clinton's mother-in-law. It's kind of nice, isn't it? It's everybody's connected. You know, not everybody's a member of the crime family, but they're at least associates of the crime family. Kind of mafia-like, isn't it? Thanks for the call, Joe. Rich, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Rich.
I didn't know. Yeah, the one, I'm so sick of all this stuff, but you know what? The one good thing that's coming out of it is that Trump has pulled the blankets off of these SOBs. And you know what? I'd love to see him rounded up at the end of the day, Roger Stone style.
I would too.
Wouldn't you love to see Comey being dragged out of his house at 4 o'clock in the morning in his onesies?
I want choppers overhead. Don't you? And I hope he lives behind a creek, so that they could put an amphibious device in there, you know, like some kind of landing boat. Come up right onto his lawn, you know? That's right. And these people are, and again, I don't think they're in any danger, but, you know, he did mention the talk about him being arrested. So obviously it's more worrisome to him than we had thought. I'm using the T word over and over again. 844-500-4242. I'm Howie Carr.
Don't touch that dial. Howie Carr will be back after this.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you in part by Orion Metal Exchange. For a free investing kit from Orion, text FREE KIT to 484848. That's FREE KIT to 484848.
Volatility in the market is a fact. What isn't so clear is what the ups and downs of the market can do to your retirement portfolio. For answers, call Kevin Frisbee at 800-989-9100. Kevin is president of Frisbee & Associates, and he's been helping people cut through the noise to create a retirement and income plan that can take you all the way to and through retirement. Call now for your free one-hour financial consultation. 800-989-9100. Kevin's book, Every Dime, Every Day, taps into his real-world experience and can help guide you to a successful retirement and make sure you never run out of money. Your analysis includes a portfolio X-ray showing any hidden fees in your current plan. He'll show you how by claiming Social Security at the right time can make a huge difference in your retirement income. Catch Kevin on the Howie Carr radio program every Thursday afternoon for a market review as well as tips on creating the retirement of your dreams. Call Kevin Frisbee today, 800-989-9100. That's 800-989-9100.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Who was your favorite actor?
Humphrey Bogart, no doubt about it. I love all the old Humphrey Bogart movies. Jimmy Cagney would be a close second.
Do you have a celebrity crush?
No celebrity crushes.
Ginger or Marianne?
I always was a Marianne person. Never was bowled over by that Hollywood look. Plus, Ginger was in more revealing attire, scantily clad.
Salty or sweet?
Neither, but if I have to pick, I'll go with sweet.
Movies or TV?
TV.
McDonald's or Burger King?
McDonald's, although I'd prefer Five Guys.
Facebook or Twitter?
Definitely Twitter. I hate Facebook.
Cake or pie?
I'm a cake guy.
Coke or Pepsi?
Diet Coke.
Coffee or tea?
Coffee, obviously.
Winter or summer?
Summer! Good Lord. Why would you want winter? It's cold and it's dark. I'm here with Dr. Bruce Houghton from Perfect Smiles in Nashua, New Hampshire. You get a lot of patients, I'm sure, who are apprehensive about veneers. What are some of the questions and fears you get when you're dealing with new patients?
Some people think they could look too fake, but true cosmetic dentistry is incredibly detail-oriented. So we put a lot of time and effort into individualizing how the smile looks, and we really make them look natural, but very, very pleasant.
You know, people are concerned. They wonder, you know, I got my teeth. Do I really want to put caps on?
Exactly. Yeah, they think they'll have that Hollywood look or fake look, but the technology that we have available and the artistry that we can create now really makes things so natural that most people, in fact, most dentists are just surprised that we can create what we can create nowadays. Everyone is different. Everyone has different facial dimensions, different bone structure, and we do everything we can to individualize treatment because there is no one perfect smile. It is your perfect smile.
Dr. Houghton, where can people find you?
So you can find us at perfectsmiles.com or call 844-A-PERFECT-SMILE, 844-A-PERFECT-SMILE.
The Moonbats always say Donald Trump isn't very bright. But what about Barack Hussein Obama? Let's listen to some of his...
The seven states, I think one left to go. I don't know what the term is in Austrian.
The Cambridge police acted stupidly.
And there has never been any man or woman more qualified for this office than Hillary Clinton.
There are neighborhoods around the country where it is easier for a 12 or 13-year-old to purchase a gun and cheaper than it is for them to get a book.
I believe in the Second Amendment. It's there written on the paper.
If we fall for, you know, a bunch of okey-doke.
A few months ago, when you were asked what's the biggest geopolitical threat facing America, you said Russia. Not Al-Qaeda. You said Russia. In the 1980s or now... calling to ask for their foreign policy back.
This is Jay in Hingham, Massachusetts.
This is Gloria from Haverhill, Mass.
Hi, this is Joe from Howie in the Hills, Florida. And this is the Howie Carr Show.
Time is running out to get your Christmas specials from the Howie Carr Show. This is a proud to be a deplorable t-shirt. And this is What Really Happened, Donald Trump's favorite book on the campaign, written by me. He's tweeted about it three times. These are a $35 value. You can get them right now for $19.99 at HowieCarrShow.com, and it will go out tomorrow. You'll have it in plenty of time for Christmas, and we have other specials. Go to HowieCarrShow.com. And click on store. We have all of our specials are $19.99, and you can also get the cheap bastard deal.
I didn't include this in the hate mail today because I didn't think it was hateful enough. But one guy did say that you. He said he hears in his sleep you mentioning that Donald Trump tweeted about your book three times. He said he's officially hearing
one,
it in his sleep.
One, two, three.
But speaking of hate,
proud to be a deplorable.
It is time for Hate Mail Monday.
Let the hate flow through you.
And it is powered, as always, by Piantedosi Baking Company, celebrating over 100 years of baking excellence since 1916. It is the most delicious, crunchy, soft, fresh bread around, so grab it at your local market. And let's get into the hate. I'm actually going to start today, Howie, with a hate mail that the mailroom manager received about yours truly, Grace Curley. To the mailroom manager, I have been listening to and loving the Howie Carr Show since the 90s.
Thank you.
This is not hate mail. This is a Dear John letter. Side note, this is
hate mail. It's a hostage note.
Maybe it's a John Deere letter. They're buying a tractor.
Ever since Howie went goo-goo over Grace, the only adult in the room is Taylor.
I did not write this. I did not write this.
I love Frank Sinatra. I'm just kidding.
I have been listening since the 90s, though.
Having Grace Factor so prominently on the show is a classic example of the dumbing down of America. But Howie is a skilled master of learning, so he helps Grace. Recently, Grace reported on someone who was bitten by a rabid animal and hoped that they had their tetanus shot. She is so dumb, but something. Okay, that was dumb. Okay, Mr. Dear John person.
Why don't you just say, like Bill Clinton, what would Bill Clinton say in this matter?
Oh, and then it gets even more hurtful.
What would Bill Clinton say?
It depends what the definition of a tetanus shot is.
Mistakes were made.
Mistakes were made. Okay. It says, what a disconnect when Howie interviews the likes of Michelle Malkin and then returns to the Grace Curley show. Ugh. It was great while it lasted. The Howie Carr show has been a part of my daily routine for over 25 years, but now I will just tune into my other favorites, sans Grace.
Boo.
But the mayor manager told me, she said they thought by sending it to me that they were going to, you know, jump over the regular channels and go to the mailer manager and she would take this into account. And she said she's actually one of my biggest fans, so it's not happening. So you should stop sending your hate mail to the mailer manager. Start sending it to Howie. He's more likely to take your opinion into account.
What you got to remember, John Deere, is the mailroom manager hired Grace, so therefore Grace can do no wrong. You know how that works, right?
Women supporting women. There's nothing wrong with that.
We'll be right back. We're going to talk about a new tax. I'm Howie Carr. It's a common phrase, better safe than sorry. Of course, sometimes you need an actual safe to be safe, and you'll find the best at Dependable Lock Service in Nashua and Liberty Safe of New Hampshire in Northampton. Both locations carry Liberty Safes, and you'll be safe when you keep your guns and other valuables in the safe made with the best materials and craftsmanship here in the USA. Visit your Liberty Safe dealer located in Nashua or Northampton, New Hampshire, or online at libertysafenewhampshire.com to find the right safe for you.
Hey, business owners and marketing professionals, would you like to advertise on the Howie Carr Radio Network? Howie's show reaches all across New England. And you know who's listening? Your next customer, client, or business lead. If you're interested in advertising on the Howie Carr Show, call 800-227-7300. That's 800-227-7300. You're listening to Howie, and so is your next customer. Call 800-227-7300 right now.
There are plenty of differences between Trump and the Democrats running for 2020, but the main one is Trump's pretty funny. Take a listen.
What advice would you give to the 25-year-old Donald Trump knowing what you know today?
Don't run for president. I'm not a drinker. I can honestly say I never had a beer in my life, okay? It's one of my only good traits. I don't drink. Whenever they're looking for something good, I say, I never had a glass of alcohol. I've never had alcohol. Can you imagine if I had? What a mess I'd be. I'd be the world's worst.
Other countries, big countries, India and others, we had to pay because they considered them a growing country. They were a growing country. I said, what are we? Are we allowed to grow too? Okay. No, are we allowed to grow?
I try like hell to hide that bald spot, folks. I work harder. Doesn't look bad. Hey, we're hanging in.
I should have saved the Pocahontas thing for another year because I've destroyed her political career and now I won't get a chance to run against her and I would have loved it. I don't want to knock out all of the good stuff and end up with somebody that's actually got talent. That would be terrible.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate. Howie Carr.
If you could go back in time and give your younger self advice, what would you say?
Get a state job, because behind the job comes the pension.
What's the best advice anyone's ever given you?
Most advice is pretty forgettable.
What's the best money you've ever spent?
The investment I made to leave the corporate radio prison I was in. The worst people I ever worked for, no doubt about it. I'd probably be dead if I were still working for them.
If you were on a deserted island and you could only bring three things, what would you bring?
A radio, a Wi-Fi system, obviously, and a computer. And I would bring some books. Don't ask me which books. Too hard a question.
What was your dad's job when you were growing up?
My dad worked as a resort hotel manager. He worked in Florida at the Breakers in the winter, and then he worked at the Mountain View House, as it was called then, in Whitefield, New Hampshire, and various other places.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Show.
Thank you, New England, for supporting Music Drives Us. Since 2006, we have used the power of music to benefit communities throughout the six states of New England. During this time, we've proudly supported more than 200 schools and donated upwards of 1,000 instruments. And this year, we're getting ready to donate all over again. Our work is made possible through your continued support of our musical mission. Whether you donated, volunteered at our events, attended our concerts, or engaged with us on social media, thank you. We hope you'll stay tuned with what we have in store for this year, because it'll be our best year yet. Visit us at musicdrivesus.org. That's musicdrivesus.org. Or follow us at Music Drives Us on social. Together, we can keep music in our schools.
And now, a minute of wisdom from Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez.
Millennials and people and, you know, Gen Z and all these folks that come after us are looking up, and we're like, the world is going to end in 12 years if we don't address climate change. And your biggest issue is, your biggest issue is, how are we going to pay for it? And like, this is the war. This is our World War II.
I think that there's a lot of people more concerned about being precisely, factually, and semantically correct than about being morally right.
But being factually correct is important.
It's absolutely important.
And if we work our butts off to make sure that we take back all three chambers of Congress, all three chambers of government, the presidency, the Senate, and the House in 2020, we can't start working in 2020.
Enough with the fake news. You need to listen to Honest Howie's History. In my new weekly podcast, I take you behind the scenes of the most talked about news events and compare them to the past. We're going to go back 100 years here, but let's start with the latest politician in the Kennedy family's crosshairs. Whatever happened to the Massachusetts State Police? You know, Hermann Goering, the Nazi. Nobody thought that there was any conspiracy there. Of course he was going to kill himself. Honest Howie's History. Listen today at HowieCarrShow.com.
You're listening to The Howie Carr Show. And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
How did you come up with the name VB?
My first producer and I both had steady girlfriends, or we were married or whatever. And VB was always saying that we were whipped, if you know what I mean. Finally, I said, you don't even have a girlfriend. I've never seen you with a female. As a matter of fact, I don't think you have ever had sex. You are just a virgin boy.
What is your biggest fear?
That Donald Trump will not be reelected in 2020, and that some horrible Democrat will come in and finish off the destruction of this once great country.
Out of all of your daughters, who is the least like you and why?
Probably Charlotte, even though we went to the same high school, Deerfield Academy. She has a different sense of her responsibilities than I do. Let me put it that way. She has a different regard for money. She's not a cheap bastard, in other words. Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
Joe Biden might be running for president in 2020, so we should play some of his greatest hits.
Barack and I finally reduced the disparity in sentencing, which we've been fighting to eliminate, and crack cocaine versus powder cocaine. Correct. It was a big mistake when it was made. We thought, we were told by the experts that crack, you never go back.
You cannot go to a 7-Eleven or a Dunkin' Donuts unless you have a slight Indian accent.
If you want to protect yourself, get a double-barrel shotgun. If there's ever a problem, just walk out on the balcony, put that double-barrel shotgun, and fire two blasts.
They're going to put you all back in chains.
Give me a break. That's a bunch of malarkey.
A three-letter word. Jobs. J-O-B-S. Jobs.
One man stands ready to deliver change we desperately need. A man I'm proud to call my friend. A man who will be the next president of the United States, Barack America.
If your hair loss is finally bothering you enough to do something about it, I've got really great news for you. If you've ever wanted a hair transplant and thought it was too expensive, listen up.
Better strap yourself in. It's time for the Howie Carr Show.
Would you agree that the FISA court was also given false information by the FBI?
I think that's fair.
I have total confidence that the FISA process was followed. I think the notion that FISA was abused here is nonsense.
Gross negligence, or they intended to do it. They intended to lie to the FISA court.
As director, you are responsible for this. I was responsible for this, and if I were still there, I'd be doing what Chris Wray is doing, is figuring out, so how did this happen, and is it systemic?
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
Sometimes it's better late than never, and sometimes it's just too damn late. And in this case, Comey is about 2 years too late.
I was overconfident in those, because he's right. There was real sloppiness. 17 things that either should have been in the applications or at least discussed and characterized differently. It was not acceptable, and so he's right. I was wrong.
Who's your Captain Howie Carr.
Well, maybe it turns upon how we understand the word. Yeah, I think you're mischaracterizing both what the FBI knew and what Mr. Horowitz says in his report. I mean, there's a number of tricky things to that. Yeah, that's not the way it works, though.
Sniveling, obsequious weasel of a human being.
But the American people, especially your viewers, need to realize they were given false information about the FBI. It's honest, it is not political, it is flawed.
Unchained and unstoppable.
On July 5th, 2016, at the end of James Comey's news conference where he exonerated Hillary Clinton in the email server scandal, I declared him to be a dirty cop. Nothing proved it more than his interview yesterday with Chris Wallace.
Rump swabs, hacks, and moon bats beware. It's Howie Carr.
On Friday evening, it was announced that the Massachusetts state income tax rate would finally be going down to 5% again. A mere 30 years after it was increased from 5% to 5.95% as part of a temporary emergency that would end in 18 months. 18 months turned into 30 years. So the tax rate is finally coming down to where it belonged 20 years after a referendum question was passed to repeal it, after they'd stalled and stonewalled and lied and delayed for 10 years before that. And then they delayed another 20 years. So now that's ending. So just in time for that to end, there is a new tax coming up. A second tax is going to be imposed on gasoline and diesel fuel Tal Duval, a.k.a. Charlie Baker, gets his way. And they're going to do it with 11 other states in the Northeast. It's called the Transportation Climate Initiative, TCI. It's better known as a tax. And the way to think of it is a tax, a second tax on gasoline. They're going to announce it tomorrow. They're going to fight global warming, unless, of course, they have to postpone the announcement because of the snowstorm. It's the way it works sometimes, you know. As I said earlier, God has an ironic sense of humor, and we're all hoping it will have to be postponed. That's the positive side of the impending winter snowstorm in the fall. Anyway, joining us now in the studio, he stopped by, is State Representative Dave DeCoste, and he's from Norwell, and he's the guy who's going to file legislation to stop this. So he's got several co-sponsors, but Tell us some more about this, Dave.
You want the transportation overview and then what we're trying to do. Well, you summed it up pretty well, Harry. You know, Howie, what this will do is create essentially kind of a quasi-federal bureaucracy that will stretch everywhere from Virginia right up the eastern seaboard to Maine. And it will be...
There's safety in numbers here. It's like a mob getting together to attack somebody.
And in this case, it's everyone who uses gasoline.
Yeah, which is everybody.
Which is everyone. Although, looking at it, let's face it, it's going to fall on some people much harder than others. And they happen to be, in my case, my constituents who live in Norwell, Hanover, and Rockland, in addition to a whole bunch of other folks who use the highways to basically get to work,
right,
and to conduct their businesses. But what this will do is be an agreement against, again, those 11 states running from Maine all the way down to Virginia along the Atlantic seaboard. And it would create an enormous bureaucracy. That is to be determined, but certainly it would be an enormous democracy.
You call it a bureaucracy. I call it a hackorama.
Well, that's a better term, but it'll be at a kind of a regional federal level. Think of it as kind of like the Massport of the East Coast.
It's even more frightening than I had thought it was when you put it in those terms.
But the problem with that, there are a number of problems. Number one, there might be a problem against, and I think there is, I'm not a lawyer, but for those people familiar with the Mass State Constitution, this will amount to taxation without representation. They can increase the cost of gasoline, and the legislature will have no say in how much or how long. And in what increments. And they also will have no say, of course, in the spending component of that. And the second part of that has a lot of folks in the other party really concerned. So I think they're going to have some problem with that in the legislative.
It's the Massachusetts state government under Charlie Baker. You know, I mean, they've done such a great job with their stewardship of so many agencies.
There you go.
The RMV, the Mass State Police.
The MBTA.
There
you are. Well, there are your three or four more role models for what this could be, except it could be everybody from the governor of Maine right down to the governor.
There'd be even less oversight than for those agencies.
Correct. And to his credit, thus far, Governor Sununu has stood solid, and he might be the one kink in this plan that holds everything up. As my peers from the northern part of the state will say, if we start raising taxes, and potentially this could go up, and I think you've reviewed it. I heard you speak about it a few times. California now has gasoline taxes over $4 a gallon. And I can tell you, sitting on the Transportation Committee and listening to, and they're usually folks either from the bureaucracies or some government or indirectly funded nonprofit come and call for higher taxes, and they
it's a way to control emissions.
Well, it's I think
representative. That's all this is about.
It's a way to, and it's also a way to control people. But you have, you know, I've heard proposals for congestion pricing and tolls. I personally, as we spoke,
yeah, the Globe is into congestion pricing.
Yeah, right.
That's their thing.
And as one nurse from Hanover wrote to me, she doesn't have, when she needs to get into BIDC, she doesn't have the ability to, or Mass General, she works at both, she doesn't have the ability to adjust her time level. She needs to be there. And so the fact that she's coming in at a time that some bureaucrat finds inconvenient, you know, will of course make her pay more money, just simply earn a living, and that's true for, you know, how many more people?
How could a Republican governor support something like this?
Well,
how can anybody who believes in the Constitution? I mean, this is a violation of the Constitution. Don't all taxes have to originate in the legislature?
Hence the problem with the constitutional aspect of this. Yes, and I think there'd probably be immediate lawsuits. Hopefully, we won't get that far. I'll have to sit down and listen to what the governor has. I haven't heard him speak about this directly.
Well, he's going to say it's not a tax. They don't, you know, this is going to be imposed on businesses, and they don't have to pass it on.
Well, even Transportation Secretary Pollack was quoted as being concerned about the ability to implement this along with the gas tax that the legislature wants to impose. And I think they'd like to add on, another 12 or 15 cents a gallon.
It's 50 cents a gallon is not enough. I mean, with the federal and the state, apparently. Plus we pay the excise taxes, plus we pay the tolls, plus we pay the sales tax when we buy a new vehicle. I mean, how much more do they need?
Well, there are a lot of people. There are a lot of people that need to be hired, I suppose, and that's kind of the cynical way to look at it. But in some cases, that I think that plays a role. But more specifically, you know, this was actually looked at being implemented very seriously by Washington State. And they studied it and came to the conclusion that the amount that the bureaucracy would cost would be less than the amount raised through the cap and trade program. So maybe when, because again, we're all waiting for the specifics. Maybe when the numbers are crunched for the specifics, it will be shown that this just can't support even the bureaucracy. And I strongly suspect that's
isn't
the case.
Isn't Pennsylvania is getting cold feet on this too, right?
Well, I hope so. Yeah,
and it's a legislative thing again, I think.
Well,
isn't
then
it?
The GOP controls both, if I'm not mistaken, they control both houses of their legislature there. So I'm sure they'll be able to raise much stronger opposition. I know the governor's in the other party, mm-hmm. but a lot of skepticism regarding this, and rightly so. I mean, there is one in the Democrat Party. I won't name him, but he's very fluent with these issues on the Transportation Committee, and he seems to think that this could not only apply to diesel and gasoline, but might also apply to natural gas and fuel oil, the way it's written. So we'll see the details of this.
Well, but remember when Clinton came in, I think mm-hmm. they tried to pass the, what do they call it, the BTU tax.
Right.
And Joe Moakley took a look at it. He was still alive then, mm-hmm. the congressman from South Boston. And he just thought it was going to destroy everybody in Massachusetts.
Right.
And they put an end to it.
There are so many things that are wrong about this tax, but to probably Congressman Moakley's point, this is regressive. This falls on lower income earners far worse than it does, if you're a bureaucrat with Massport making $120,000
right.
a year, you're going to be touched by that far less than somebody who's making $50,000 or $60,000.
I guess Charlie Baker, though, he'll give up his state police vehicle and start taking the commuter rail in.
Well,
it's the least he can do to protect polar bears since all the rest of us are going to have to do it.
I have found that sitting on the Transportation Committee, the folks who are most the most ardent supporters of higher taxes seem to be the folks who live in within, say, the Newton-Wellesley belt and everything in there. But as you get further out, and this has to do with both parties from Boston, there's much less enthusiasm for raising taxes on work. And I think even our folks, our friends over to the much more liberal side, particularly some who have recently elected, are having second thoughts about that because they realize what this does to the average man or woman trying to support, raise a family, and get to and from work and everything you need to do.
You know, at least 5 years ago, when they tried to push through the automatic gas tax, or 9 years ago when they tried to put through the sales tax on the excise tax on alcohol, we had a chance to vote it down, and we did it in referendums. I mean, granted, that's a very cumbersome way to do it and very time-consuming, expensive, et cetera. But I mean, in this case, would we even have that option?
Well, here's that's another problem. That's one of probably the most insidious things about the TCI is that not only would we not be able to rescind it, you would have a group of unelected, again, we have to look at the details, but it looks like you'll have a group of unelected bureaucrats using some formula and some goal to determine how much more every year or so that the tax on how frequently the tax needs to be raised.
This looks like this. I mean, this seems like a kind of a local version of the Elizabeth Warren's thing, CFPB, the Consumer Finance Protection Board, which is this agency that's set up to run sort of outside the normal congressional. And it's going to be ruled unconstitutional by the Supreme Court. If we had an honest judiciary, we wouldn't have to worry about this.
Well, I hope, wouldn't it be ripe if Judge Kavanaugh wrote that decision so she could she could read it from there. But, I think...
Unfortunately, it's not going to be decided by the U.S. Supreme Court. It's going to be decided by our courts here,
Well, with at the federal level.
Yeah.
But the federal,
oh, but you're saying if it's 12 states, maybe it would be decided.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Wouldn't it be ripe if he could write that decision?
Oh, that would be. I'd love to see that.
Yeah.
But that might be years. I mean, God only knows how much money would be out by the time it reached the Supreme Court.
But I can tell you the type of people that I have seen who testify in front of it, and I don't mean to smear them up, but many of them just seem to be very divorced from reality, or at least the reality I see. The reality I see with my constituents trying to earn a living down on the
right.
South Shore. They're very, very...
I read their postings on the websites, okay. And you're right. They're out of their minds. Right. But we'll take some calls when we come back for Representative Dave DeCoste, and we're trying to fight this thing. The big announcement is tomorrow, pending, could be postponed because of the snowstorm. Global warming is a big problem, as you know, unless there's a snowstorm. 844-500-4242. I'm Howie Carr.
Keep it here. The captain will be back after this.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you in part by Orion Metal Exchange. For a free investing kit from Orion, text FREE KIT to 484848. That's FREE KIT to 484848. I'm here with Dr. Bruce Houghton from Perfect Smiles in Nashua, New Hampshire. Dr. Houghton, tell us about the state-of-the-art procedures that can help many people look 10 to 15 years younger.
As we age, we do lose these proper proportions to our faces. And so if you're deficient in your chin or mid-face, we can create the proper proportions and make you look great. Sometimes we use orthodontics to change the look of the face. Sometimes we just use the teeth themselves, and it creates the right support for a beautiful face. They're all non-surgical procedures.
There's some pretty complex cases that you deal with. Give me an example of a tough case.
Well, some cases. People just are missing a lot of teeth. I get a lot of people that come in and think that I cannot solve their problems because they're too great, but I really can. We've been doing this for over 35 years, and there isn't much that we haven't seen.
So even if you're missing a few teeth, or your teeth are discolored, or you're very embarrassed, there's no reason not to come in for a consultation, right?
Absolutely. New techniques, new technology, things are available to us that we never had before, and we can handle just about everything.
Where can people find you?
So you can find us at perfectsmiles.com or call 844-8 A Perfect Smile.
Cory Booker said it best.
There are definitely moments where you listen to Joe Biden and you just wonder.
Here's stumbling and mumbling Bo Biden, Joe Biden.
David Duke, the former leader of the KKK.
The Ku Klux Klan is the Ku Klux Klan.
8 more years of Donald Trump will change America in a fundamental way. But if Donald Trump is reelected, Freudian slip, and the demagogues around the world.
We also have a mechanism to control drug prices. Folks at the health department in the United States, HHS.
They would put 720 million million women back in the workforce.
I never ever thought that I'd see what I saw in Charlotte.
Would you or would you not rejoin the TPP, yes or no?
I would not rejoin the TTP. Well, they're going out and getting G5 and going to dominate. I mean, what are we doing?
The bills that the future president here, that the senator's talking about.
I'm here with Dr. Bruce Houghton from Perfect Smiles in Nashua, New Hampshire. Dr. Houghton, tell us about the state-of-the-art procedures that can help many people look 10 to 15 years younger.
As we age, we do lose these proper proportions to our faces. And so if you're deficient in your chin or mid-face, we can create the proper proportions and make you look great. Sometimes we use orthodontics to change the look of the face. Sometimes we just use the teeth themselves, and it creates the right support for a beautiful face. They're all non-surgical procedures.
There's some pretty complex cases that you deal with. Give me an example of a tough case.
Well, some cases. People just are missing a lot of teeth. I get a lot of people that come in and think that I cannot solve their problems because they're too great, but I really can. We've been doing this for over 35 years, and there isn't much that we haven't seen.
So even if you're missing a few teeth, or your teeth are discolored, or you're very embarrassed, there's no reason not to come in for a consultation, right?
Absolutely. New techniques, new technology, things are available to us that we never had before, and we can handle just about everything.
Where can people find you?
So you can find us at perfectsmiles.com or call 844-8 Perfect Smile.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Is Kennedy Babylon 2 your last book?
No, if I think of another topic for a book I want to write, I'll go for it. But I think it's the last of my Kennedy Babylon series. I made Kennedy Babylon 2 kind of long because I wanted to get everything in there. Now there's other stuff I could write about, but I'm Kennedy now.
Since having the sleeve operation, do you miss not eating big meals?
No, I don't. I can still eat what I used to eat. I just can't eat as much. I'm now very surprised how much I used to eat. I'm surprised at how much people I eat with consume. It's just hard to believe that I used to eat that much. But no, it's not a problem.
How is Mr. Gooner since Pearl's passing?
Mr. Gooner is drowning his sorrows in food.
What is the most trouble you ever got into as a kid?
My father was giving me grief one time up at Moosehead Lake in Maine, and I threw a rock at him. He didn't much like that.
Ah!
Hi, my name is Jane Lucas, and I am from the town of South China, Maine.
This is Al from Merrimack, New Hampshire.
Hey, I'm Angela from Brewster on the Cape, and this is the one and the only Howie Carr Show.
Break-in spike every single year during the holidays. Right now, the state government is trying to break into your wallet. Fortunately, right now, SimpliSafe is offering a huge discount on home security systems and a free security camera with your order. For a limited time, go to SimpliSafeHowie.com to take advantage of this offer. SimpliSafeHowie.com. Taylor, what's the poll question? What are the results thus far?
Who is shiftier, Adam Schiff or James Comey?
Comey.
47% say Comey's the shiftier.
It's getting closer all the time. Here's what, before we take some calls for Dave DeCoste, the state rep from Norwell, who's fighting this. Serious question. Can you have your guest explain the mechanism of this program, its effectiveness in California, and what will the tax revenue be earmarked for? Quote unquote earmarked. You should put that in quotes, like sunsetted. You know, sunset doesn't mean what it really means. Go ahead and answer.
Okay. Well, the mechanisms aren't determined yet because we don't know. The final report isn't done. We were speaking about that off air. The final report isn't done. But basically, if you look what California does, you have a system where, again, the bureaucrats will determine, appointed bureaucrats will determine the amount of taxes they need to funnel it back into what will be climate public works.
Alleged
climate public works. And you alluded, I don't know how much of that public works is going to be to fund pensions that are underfunded
right.
and so forth.
Like the automatic gas tax. Right. It turned out half of it was going to go to MBTA pensions, i.e. the Bulgers.
And so forth. And the mechanisms. So the mechanisms are it's a cap and trade general mechanism, but we don't know yet because they haven't given us the specifics of the program. That will come out later. Whether or not, if your goal is to raise taxes, then California has certainly been quite effective in that regard. Yeah.
And it's had no effect, of course, on any climate.
I don't think so.
Exactly. So what should people do if they're concerned about this? Who should they?
I would call the, and I don't know the state, I think it's 722-1000. 617, but call the state house, call your state representative, call the governor's office, call your state senator, and let them know that you're concerned about this. You want to know the complete details so that everyone can do an analysis of how this has worked, who will be appointed, and if there's a cap, I think, the cap and trade, the only thing that won't be capped is the amount of taxes that can be levied on the people who work for a living.
Exactly. You know? Exactly. This is a dangerous precedent. What do you need a legislature for if you have this?
Well, and there are both Democrats, Republicans, and Independents who've raised that question with me. It really is a question mark. But it's tough to evaluate something that we only know the general. We need, you need to know the specifics, and then you have to have the folks we rely on read through.
Right. The announcement's coming tomorrow. Gary, you're next with Howie Carr and Representative Dave DeCoste. Go ahead, Gary.
Hey, Howie, over the weekend I heard something like the MBTA needs $1 billion to collect fares to prevent these fare jumpers, yet they only take in for annual revenue of fares $700 million. Now, I understand spending $1 billion, they can collect the fares for maybe 5 years, but who's to say 2 years from now, Tom Duvall doesn't say, hey, listen, we need less people driving into Boston, we're going to have the fares for free.
I don't know who's, I mean, one of the candidates for mayor is already, next year, has already proposed that, so that could happen. Dave DeCoste, we'll stay in touch with you, okay?
Well, thank you, Howie.
I'm Howie Carr. Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Would you say you're more like your mom or your dad?
No, I don't think I ended up being like either of them, now that I think about it. My mother worked hard, but she never really learned how to make a lot of money. And my father didn't work so hard, but he had a good personality. He was good with people. He was better than me with people. That's what I'm saying. I'm not like either one of them, I don't think.
Did you have any siblings?
Yes, I have a brother, a younger brother.
What was your favorite subject in school?
Well, all kinds of history. I loved all kinds of history.
If you could have three houses, besides the ones you already have, anywhere in the world, where would they be?
I wouldn't mind having another house in Palm Beach on Clark Avenue. Maybe a place in southern Maine. I don't need a third place.
Didn't you already have a house in Maine?
I did. It was on an island. It was not a good fit for the mailroom manager.
I've heard the house was haunted. Is that true?
Yes. And my wife didn't really care that much for my relatives. Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300. Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300. And now, another minute of Madam Speaker, Nancy Pelosi.
But, again, don't...
You have these wings, AOC and her group on one side.
That's like five people. They would say, play games, and then they'd say, open sesame. Except we don't say sesame, we say open Biden. But no, I because we are not. We have no, the number is growing. We have 91 women. There are 115 women in Congress, 116. 15 are Republican, 91 are Democrats. I happen to be a manifestation of the women power that is coming forth now, but only one manifestation. It was like getting kicked in the back by a mule constantly. It was physical. It was so unbelievable. The Times found Lincoln. Not to be presumptuous to put ourselves in those categories, but the Times have found us.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
So a few months back, the president was in the area. I think it was in New Hampshire, in Manchester. And he was, you know, doing one of his speeches in one of the swing states. And there was a ruckus up in the nosebleed section. And he looked up there and he saw a couple of people scuffling. And he just made... He said to one guy who was being dragged out, he said, look at that guy. look at that fat guy. He needs to go home and do some exercise. He's going home to mama and all this stuff. And we were all amused because we remember what happened in almost 4 years ago now in Worcester, where he started talking about food stamps and a big fat guy went crazy. And he said, look at that guy. He wasn't complaining until I started talking about food stamps and they dragged him out. And it was funny. And I put a picture of it in what really happened and all that. So I chuckled like everybody else. And then, but the next day it turned out that the guy who was taken out was a big Trump supporter. And then I read further down in the story and I knew the guy. His name was Frank Dawson. I know him from the federal courthouse in Boston. And
turns out he was talking to you.
He was, because he didn't see me rip the signs away from those three people that were sitting near us. And they were trying to cause a ruckus. And they jumped up and they start yelling stuff that I don't even care what they were yelling. But it wasn't going to happen beside me because I'm trying to listen to my president. But I think he thought I was part of it, but I wasn't. I was the good part of it.
What did he say to you?
He said, hey, that guy needs to lose a little weight. Everything's good. I love the guy. He's the best thing that ever happened in this country.
So I thought about calling Frank, but then I said, I don't want to embarrass him. You know, maybe he doesn't want to talk about it, even though he was on Fox right then. You heard him. And so I just kind of let it slide. But he sent me something the other day. And so he said, I thought I might hear from you after the incident in New Hampshire. And I said, well, I didn't want to embarrass you. And he said, I'm not embarrassed. And I said, okay, well, let's come on. I'm going to wish him a Merry Christmas. And, you know, and just talk to him. So Frank Dawson, thanks for being with us here on the Howie Carr Show.
Hey, Howie, Merry Christmas to you, too. And it's funny the way you're telling the story. I was never taken out of there. That was what we call the fake news.
Really?
Security approached me, and they asked me for my contact info, and then they got back to me, and then that's when the president had called me. And it was kind of funny because I had more people asking me, what was it like to get thrown out? Well, I wasn't thrown out.
Very fake news.
So what did the...
But you're on top of this thing, which is great. And, you know, the fake news is out there all the time. Talk show hosts like you around the country who Donald Trump greatness because you tell the truth and the American people are finally smartening up. And I know that you know that I know who Bob Mueller is because of our relationship in the masters in the U.S. In the attorney's office. And that's even funnier, you know, because we see what he has done, you know?
Yeah.
To our president.
No, I know. He was the U.S. attorney briefly, but he worked under Bill Weld for a number of years, and he was in Boston. And these four guys were rotting in prison for a crime they didn't commit. Everybody knew they didn't commit the crime. It was even in books as early as 1973, and they just continued to rot. And people like Bill Weld sent letters saying, don't let these guys out of prison. And Mueller did nothing about it. And finally, they get out of prison after all these years, and they sue the government for $100 million, which they won, and it wasn't a frivolous lawsuit. And during the trial, the plaintiffs, the four guys who'd been in prison for 35 years for a murder they didn't commit, they were trying to get the documents from the FBI, and Mueller was the head of the FBI, and he refused to hand over the documents. And Nancy Gardner had to run.
As the Fitz say, you're spying because you know about the corrupt deep state. I mean, it's pathetic. And I actually was listening to the show, and I heard you talking about Nancy Pelosi, and she says, I felt like I was kicked by a mule. Well, Howie, believe it or not, my nickname in high school was Mule, and I'd like to give her a kick, to tell you the truth. And but you are the best, without a doubt. You know, more people are informed because of what you have to say on the air, and you know everyone just does not know. And you go into depth and you explain it. You and Fox News. If it wasn't for you guys, we'd be in the deep state.
I'm telling you, Frank. The thing was, you know, when Nancy Gardner started, right, the judge who threatened basically to fine Mueller in contempt of court if he didn't turn over these exculpatory documents about these guys, you know, she started writing this stuff for the New York Times when Trump was attacking him, saying no one has ever questioned the integrity of Robert Mueller, and then you know, God God love this guy, this lawyer that represented one of those four guys. He went into the records and he found the letter that she had written in 2006 threatening him with contempt of court if he didn't turn over the documents. These, you know, Frank, these people are all so duplicitous, you know, and they all have these, pedigrees, impeccable academic credentials, but they're so dishonest, you know?
You got that right, 100%. And it's funny because Nancy Gertner was such a liberal judge too, and Bart Mueller was a career prosecutor, Vietnam Marine hero. And but bottom line is he can still be a jerk, and he still can be part of the deep state, which he was. But he did his job, and the president is exonerated. To use Jim Comey's words, who's another piece of work. Don't get me started on him. I was on a protection detail with them once in over the Brookline Country Club, and like he walked in like he owned the place. He refused to shut his phone off over there, and nobody was supposed to have phones, you know? And it's just like, you know, a pompous ass at best.
Yeah. I mean, that's why I voted in the poll to say that he's worse than Schiff, because, you know, at least, you theoretically have a way to get rid of Schiff. There was no way to get rid of Comey all these years. He was just he was an unelected bureaucrat. And you're right. Yeah. He was more arrogant than somebody who has to answer, at least again theoretically, to the voters every couple of years. It's just,
and Howie, to tell you the truth, I think he had political aspirations himself, if not for the presidency, for at least the Senate, because he's such a pompous ass, and his ego is the hugest thing about him. He may be 6'9", but his ego is like freaking 12 feet. You know?
Yeah. I know. I think the only thing he should be running for now is the border, Frank. He's not going anywhere. So listen, have you talked to the president again? Or are you going to talk to him again?
Highly, it's ironic. I've never talked to him. I would love to talk to him. I don't want to talk to him. I want to play golf with him, for God's sake. But, you know, he is a busy guy. He's a busy guy, and you know that. I mean, you know, if you take 5 phone calls, next thing you know, an hour goes by and works. You know what I mean? And I love the guy. He's doing a lot for this country. He's the best president that I have ever seen. And compared to the last guy who was a pamp load at best. And I hope that whatever happens, it's going to show that Obama had his fingers all over this thing. I absolutely believe that.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah.
Community organizer.
Yeah. Paul, the UPS guy, says, Howie, I know someone who knows Frank, too, and was there with him. I think Frank has a voicemail from Trump. You do, Frank, but you didn't want us to play it on the air, and I don't blame you, because somebody could grab it off the podcast.
That was nice. I respect the fact that. But I just wanted to let, you know, so I really...
But what did he say? Why don't you tell us tell everybody what he said to you in the voicemail?
Basically, the phone message says, hey, Frank, this is the best president that you have ever had, or something like that, and I want to thank you for tonight. He did a great job. He thanked me like 3 or 4 times. He basically told me who I was. You know, he could see, and then he had talked to the security. And, everyone was saying, well, he was calling a friend. He really wasn't, because he was looking up there. He's in the middle of doing a speech, and a little ruckus breaks out. He's trying to, you know, to figure out what's going on.
Right.
And he's got television, and I got television, because I had thought he had said I was overweight, but he wasn't talking to me. And I was going to send you some pictures. I think I sent you one picture that shows that, hey, if I'm overweight, I got some issues. I might have a little bit in the front because I like Bud Light, but, I go to the gym 5 or 6 days a week, and, I want to keep healthy and strong because I got 4 grandkids and 1 grandkid on the way. So.
Yeah, the other thing too is, Frank, you know this. I mean, if you're a public speaker and you have success with a line, especially in one area, like he did in Worcester, Manchester, it's kind of the same area. So he just was going, going back to his repertoire of a great hit too. That's another thing I think that was probably involved. But
absolutely, because he's not a politician. He doesn't read off teleprompters. He shoots from the hip, and he knows what he's saying. You know, he doesn't have to think. He just comes out quick, you know what I mean? Just quick.
Yeah.
Like, he could talk in a bar room with anybody. Obama could never talk in a bar room with anybody. And Trump doesn't drink, so, you know, so.
No, I know. Man, I can't imagine Obama talking to anybody, you know, unless he's...
And I gotta mention, I put out on Facebook, I put a couple of things out about Comey and Schiff and everything else, and and I got a response from one guy. He told me to make sure I say hi to you.
Oh, that's
George
good.
Catchman.
That's good. Let's play the cut from the rally where he's talking about the weight. Let's hear that. Hold on, Frank.
That guy's got a serious weight problem. Go home, start exercising. Get him out of here, please. Got a bigger problem than I do. Got a bigger problem than all of us.
That's good.
I'm glad you can laugh about it, Frank. And I'm glad you like the guy. I always knew you did, but you know, that's great. I'm glad you got in contact with me too. And I do want to wish you a Merry Christmas. And
hey, if we can say that now, Merry Christmas to you and you and your family and everyone at WRK Radio. As I'm sitting in a parking lot at Frank's restaurant in Royfield, Mass. For God's sake.
All right, Frank Dawson, thank you. Thanks for checking in with us, and you know, keep making America great, and I'll talk to
all
you
right,
soon.
Howie, take care. I'll keep in touch. I'll send you some more pictures to show you the development of how that whole thing occurred.
Oh, okay. I appreciate that. Thank you. Thanks, Frank. Thanks. 844, that's Frank Dawson. He's the one that had the, you know, the president was talking about him, and then the president called him and said, you know, I didn't really, you know, whatever. You were doing okay, Frank. Thanks for defending me and ripping down the signs of the demonstrators. 8445.
Now he goes home and his mom says, "What the hell have you just done?"
8-4. It's still a good line, though. You know, he got the wrong guy once, but I mean, it's I hope to hear him using that line again as the campaign kicks into high gear starting next January. 844-500-4242. I'm Howie Carr.
Don't touch that dial. Howie Carr will be back after this.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you in part by the Dirty Rats podcast. Everyone is raving about Dirty Rats. Available wherever you get your podcasts, as well as DirtyRatsPodcast.com. Binge Dirty Rats today. It's free.
It's wisely written. All things come to those who wait. Case in point, it's Matthew's Carol's time. The long drought is over, and you can now quench your thirst and nurture your soul with our heartfelt yet accurate lyrics.
Matthew's Brothers makes our windows all the way up north in Belfast, Maine. Even though we're in New England, we build them to withstand a hurricane. Rain will spatter, teeth will chatter, we trudge up through the blinding snow and get to work. For 165 years, it's a legacy we will not shirk. We know that we're not great singers. We were told to practice and said we did. Still, our carols sound way better than that one from Rennie's or Cars for Kids.
All of us here at Matthews Brothers wish you and your loved ones peace, health, and prosperity, and may you have a wicked awesome 2020.
Matthews Brothers, Matthews Brothers, Matthews with one T. America's oldest window manufacturer are we.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
You are known as a cheap bastard. Which one of your daughters is the cheapest and why?
Charlotte is the cheapest, and I say that because she's always using my credit card. We keep changing the credit cards over and over again, and she keeps busting in and using them again. Most recently, just this week, she spent $75 at AT&T.
What's the cheapest thing you do now to save money?
The cheapest thing I do currently to save money, I guess, is I take all the bottles and cans back to the market basket every weekend. I always like to save that money. You know, I can't stand to throw those bottles and cans away and have the unclaimed returns go to the state of Massachusetts for illegal aliens.
Do you recycle?
Yes, I do recycle. When I got on the town meeting, I saw that the town dump was probably the only department in the town that was running in the black, and it's because of all the recycling that was going on, so I try to keep my taxes down that way. John, what happened at Perfect Smiles when you went?
The initial consultation was easy. In the past, they just hand me a clipboard to fill out the forms, but that's not how it worked at Perfect Smiles. What was nice was it was a true consultation. They asked me my medical history for what I wanted to get out of the treatment plan. For me, I lived with TMJ. I'd literally have to crack my jaw throughout the day to relieve the pressure. I'd get headaches throughout the day. I'd be in pain. When I was at Perfect Smiles, they asked me what I wanted to get out of the treatment. You know, as a joke, I just said, geez, I'd love you to be able to fix my TMJ. And I was surprised because Dr. Houghton specializes in working with patients like me that have TMJ.
What were the results of visiting Dr. Houghton at Perfect Smiles?
Not only did I walk out of that office with a perfect smile, but he fixed my TMJ. It was a life-changing event. People tell me now that my smile's amazing. People would say, geez, John, your teeth look so great. I never realized my teeth looked so bad before. Now I take a look at the before and after pictures, and I'm amazed.
Go to Perfect Smiles in Nashua, New Hampshire, or visit their website, perfectsmiles.com.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Did you have any pets when you were younger?
I had a cat named Dexter. That was my first pet. And then I had possession of two poodles when I lived in Palm Beach, Princess and Frisky. They weren't really my dogs, but I took care of them. They lived with me. So they were my dogs. I love those poodles.
When you were a kid, what was the best gift you ever received?
I got this wooden fort from FAO Schwartz in Palm Beach about the age of 6 or 7. 10 soldiers to go along with it. Such a cool fort. I had that fort for like maybe close to 10 years.
What is your all-time favorite movie?
Probably Goodfellas. I love Goodfellas. I love it even more than The Godfather.
What is your favorite dessert?
Oh, that's a tough one. Probably chocolate ice cream, followed by vanilla ice cream, followed by coffee ice cream.
This is Alex from East Bridgewater, Mass.
This is Ian in Saco, Maine.
This is John Zuko from Hampton, Mass. And this is The Howie Carr Show.
Last chance for the Cheap Bastard deal. We only got a few left. The Adams Pub, and that's in Quincy. It's you can use the gift certificate at the Adams Pub. And Best Western's Inn Hotel and Waterfront Event Center. You can use it for the hotel. You can use it for the pub, and it's a great place to go just for an event. And you can save it for the summer too, when they got the great views of the harbor. And you can use it for for the event center for if you're planning an event. You can use it. It's a $125 gift certificate for $62.50. So that's a really good deal. You can get a few meals out of it at the Adams Pub, or you can get in a night close to a night at fewer than 10 left. But go to HowieCarrShow.com, HowieCarrShow.com, click on store, and it's the Cheap Bastard deal of the day, the Adams Pub. And it's the also the Best Western Adams Inn Hotel and Waterfront Event Center. Only a few left. Get on board now. It's a great Christmas gift. People think you've really splurged. And you haven't, have you? 844-500-4242. That's the toll-free number of the Howie Carr Show. And you can also, this is one of the final days, you can get the special from the Howie Carr Show, our books, Proud to Be a Deplorable T-shirt, and What Really Happened. The book about the Donald Trump campaign, a $35 value for $19.99. These deplorable T-shirts are very popular. We've got enough left for the next few days, but you want to order in the next few days to get them. Make sure you get them by Christmas. We also got Kennedy Babylon book specials, organized crime book specials, and Dirty Rats T-shirt, and the Rat Man book about Whitey. All for each one for $19.99. These are really good savings. $19.99, HowieCarrShow.com. Click on store. Steve, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Steve.
Yes, sir, Howie. First time, long time.
Thank you.
So I volunteer drive for Penquist Community Action Program.
Yes.
It's a combination Penobscot and Piscataquis County.
Right.
And they reimburse us 41 cents a mile,
mm-hmm.
and it hasn't changed for 30 years.
Yeah.
You also have KV Cap for Kennebec Valley, New Freedoms, and Waldo Community Action Program. So I don't know how they're affected, but I know we have an average of 180 drivers
mm-hmm.
volunteer, where they pay us 41 cents.
Well, I'll tell you something, Steve. Janet Mills, your governor, is all in on this TCI thing, for obvious reasons. I'm sure you're not surprised, right?
She's not thinking about the people that we take to dialysis, cancer treatment, mental health programs, mental retardation programs, United Cerebral Palsy programs, and the methadone clinics.
Yeah, I'm sure she's not. I mean, I don't think she was thinking. I don't think she's thinking about the economy of Maine in general. Or, you know, she just, you know, she's one of these people. She just wants more tax dollars. All these people do. I'm hoping Governor Sununu will stand tall in this, because if he says no to bringing New Hampshire into this, Maine and Massachusetts particularly are going to be in a real jam about putting this in. Because I mean, what are you going to, if you, you know, what's going to happen? Like the one Democrat they've got in the, that's, you know, involved with DeCoste and the Republicans is Colleen Gary. She's from Draycott. What would happen to every service station in Draycott if they put this, if suddenly they were all having to charge $4.50 a gallon and in New Hampshire it was $2.70, it'd be the end. I mean, isn't it bad? I mean, they killed off vaping. You're going to have, if you smoke menthol cigarettes, you're going to have to go to New Hampshire starting in July to get the Newports or the Cools or whatever. I mean, what are they thinking of here? They're crazy. They're not thinking. It's like the rep was saying, it's like they're not, the people that testify at these things are not in the real world, but we are in the real world. You know, even if we don't own a service station, even if we don't smoke menthol cigarettes, we understand what all this nutty stuff is doing, and it's not good. Thanks for the call, Steve, and good luck, Mike. I'm not confident what's going to happen in Maine, though. Go ahead, Mike.
Hey, Howie, quick three things. I'd love to see what the job application for Burisma looks like.
When were you first arrested for drugs? How about that?
Right.
At age 18.
Right. Yeah. Right. And it's a bonus if you get kicked out of the service for drugs. That's a bonus.
Right.
That helps.
Have you ever slept with your sister-in-law? How about that one? When was the last time you impregnated a stripper? How many times have you been to rehab? How many time zones have you been to detox in? Yeah, could be a lengthy application. Thanks, Mike. I'm Howie Carr.
Are you looking for a pre-owned car? Well, before you go to the dealership where you'll be pounced on by pushy salespeople, give the Car Guys a try. I'm Bill Papageorge, and my job is to make finding the perfect used car as easy as possible. That means I do all of the tough legwork for you. Once I figure out what you want out of a car, I go find it. I've been in this business for a long time, and I know what to look out for. I won't bring you a car unless I know it will meet or exceed your expectations. So give me a call at 800-300-4600. That is 800-300-4600.
Honest Howie is back at it again. If you've missed any of the first few episodes of Honest Howie's history, go to HowieCarShow.com, click podcasts, and start binging. Howie's covering everything from conspiring Kennedys.
I had no knowledge of it.
To the state trooper scandals.
The Massachusetts State Police has a long and honorable history.
To the very fake news.
Very fake news.
Go to HowieCarShow.com, click podcasts, and then choose Honest Howie's history. He's the most trusted name in honest news.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
So now you've broken your elbow. Have you ever broken any other bones?
When I was 8 years old, I broke my leg. I was playing touch football in Portland, and a big kid, a 15-year-old, tackled me. When I was in my 30s, I was going down the stairs, and one of the kid's toys was on the stairs, and I tripped on it and broke my foot. I lost a tooth playing touch football when I was just out of Deerfield. I got smacked in the jaw. My tooth went up, and I still have a bridge, a crown from that mishap. I have a replacement hip, and now I have a bunch of pins in my left elbow.
When do you plan to retire?
I don't plan on retiring. As an old football coach once said, once you retire, there's only one big moment left. You know what that is.
The Democrat Party is so full of loonies, social justice warriors, progressives, whatever you want to call them, that sometimes certain moonbats get overlooked. So let's take this moment to shine the woke spotlight on crazy Maisie Hirono.
I am not going to be a fool to Mitch McConnell's shenanigans. Why should any of us?
And it's not just a dog whistle, it's a bullhorn.
Bullhorns. It's racism. It's basically, for many people, it's anti-Semitic. It's white supremacy.
Why not take a stand and vote yes for it? Seems like you're trying to have it both ways. Not be hung by it politically, but also not say that you don't support it.
I disagree with you, Katie, that why should we engage in the kind of sham shenanigans that Mitch McConnell is really good at?
I'm confused.
This was just a sham.
Guess who's perpetuating all of these kinds of actions? It's the men in this country, and I just want to say to the men of this country, just shut up and step up.
I think the noose is closing, and, you know, Giuliani is like a loose cannon, and so is the president, frankly.
You're listening to The Howie Carr Show.
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
We went to the White House for the Christmas party. In your opinion, what was the highlight?
The highlight of my trip to the White House with Grace, there were two. Number one, when we walked into Trump International Hotel, which she'd been dreaming of going to, and her eyes were wide. And then when the president actually came down the stairs, her eyes were even wider. She was so in awe of being there. I really felt like King Farouk, you know? I felt like I was giving someone a really great gift that they couldn't get otherwise.
You've had some really good interviews over the years. Which one was your favorite?
I can't really say what the best interview I ever had, but one that just occurred to me was Jesse Helms, the senator from North Carolina. I interviewed him one time, and he went to high school with my mother in Monroe, North Carolina. And the first words out of his mouth were, "Howie, I know your mother before you knew your mother."
You're listening to The Howie Carr Show.
I'm here with Dr. Bruce Houghton from Perfect Smiles in Nashua, New Hampshire. You get a lot of patients, I'm sure, who are apprehensive about veneers. What are some of the questions and fears you get when you're dealing with new patients?
Some people think they could look too fake, but true cosmetic dentistry is incredibly detail-oriented. So we put a lot of time and effort into individualizing how the smile looks, and we really make them look natural, but very, very pleasant.
You know, people are concerned. They wonder, you know, I got my teeth. Do I really want to put caps on?
Exactly. Yeah, they think they'll have that Hollywood look or fake look, but the technology that we have available and the artistry that we can create now really makes things so natural that most people, in fact, most dentists are just surprised that we can create what we can create nowadays. Everyone is different. Everyone has different facial dimensions, different bone structure, and we do everything we can to individualize treatment because there is no one perfect smile. It is your perfect smile.
Dr. Houghton, where can people find you?
So you can find us at perfectsmiles.com or call 844-A-PERFECT-SMILE, 844-A-PERFECT-SMILE.
Howie Carr here. Have you looked in the mirror lately? When you see your smile, what do you think? If you're like most people, you probably wish you had whiter teeth or teeth that weren't crooked. And then you think fixing those problems will take years and will cost you more than you can afford and will likely be painful. Well, I've got good news for you. You can have a perfect smile in as few as just 3 visits to Dr. Houghton at Perfect Smiles in Nashua, New Hampshire. Using state-of-the-art cosmetic dentistry, Dr. Houghton will work with you to design the smile you want. In as little as 4 weeks from your initial visit, you'll have perfectly straight teeth and they'll shine a vibrant white. And your new perfect smile could cost you less than $100 a week. See, you can afford it. No pain, no more annoying white strips, No extractions or braces. Just a perfect smile that will make you want to look in the mirror more often. I have a perfect smile from Dr. Houghton, and now the mailroom manager does too. Now it's your turn. Go to PerfectSmiles.com for more information. That's PerfectSmiles.com. Let's be honest. Hair loss is not one of life's more enjoyable experiences. It makes you self-conscious, erodes your confidence, and causes you to waste years of your life trying to hide, camouflage, and generally obsess over the condition. In short, it pretty much sucks. Until you call DiStefano Hair Restoration, and they completely turn your life around with an IGT procedure. Whether you are looking to fill in your hairline or reverse years of hair loss, Dr. Chris Hines and his team at DiStefano Hair Restoration will create a result that will be a transformative experience. The result of my IGT procedure was quite remarkable. I now have fuller, thicker hair, so I can even wear it a bit longer. With the DiStefano difference, balding and hair loss are now optional. And no matter where you are in New England, DiStefano Hair Restoration is just a short drive away. Call now and get a free IGT consultation. Plus, financing is available with payments as low as $119 a month. Just call 1-800-858-HAIR to learn more. That's 1-800-858-HAIR. Or just visit hairman.com.
Hey, it's Brendan from Cape Gunworks. Are you looking for a new firearm or maybe some range time? Then come on down to Cape Gunworks in Hyannis. We have a brand new 20,000 square foot facility with a huge pro shop with hundreds of modern firearms and accessories. Plus, we buy and sell unique and collectible guns. If you're looking for range time, we've got 15 brand new state-of-the-art lanes open to the public. Don't have a firearm? Don't worry. We've got plenty of pistol and rifles for you to rent. Exercise your Second Amendment rights at Cape Gunworks in Hyannis and at CapeGunworks.com.
It's a common phrase, better safe than sorry. Of course, sometimes you need an actual safe to be safe, and you'll find the best at Dependable Lock Service in Nashua and Liberty Safe of New Hampshire in Northampton. Both locations carry Liberty Safes, and you'll be safe when you keep your guns and other valuables in the safe made with the best materials and craftsmanship here in the USA. Visit your Liberty Safe dealer located in Nashua or Northampton, New Hampshire, or online at libertysafenewhampshire.com to find the right safe for you.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Show.
Scarcely a Republican. And there was a reason he was Mitt Romney's running mate, because we had a rhino ticket in 2012.
Where did the expression, "How many more, Mr. Speaker? How many more?" come from?
That comes from the State House. There used to be a state rep who sometimes would talk about atrocities that were happening in crime. And he would get up there and he would say, "How many more?"